Military says it has killed 50 Hamas terrorists in that hospital. The IOC says Russian and Belarusian athletes will not be allowed to take part in the traditional parade at the opening ceremony at the Paris Olympics. Athletes from Russia and Belarus who are approved to compete at the Olympics as neutrals will have a chance only to experience the event. The Dow had 241 points, the NASDAQ adding 57 points now. More at townhall.com.
This is Dennis Prager. I am excited to announce the all-new Pragertopia Plus. You can listen to my show whenever it's convenient for you, all commercial free and all on demand. Now with Prager Plus, search topics, guests, and segments all the way back to 2010. And now a truly exciting new benefit, my monthly online video get-together for Pragertopia Plus members only. This is where for an hour each month, Pragertopia Plus members get an exclusive chance to ask me anything. That's right, anything. It's on video. I'll be talking to you and answering your questions. We may even have a special guest every now and then. I've never done this. Submit your questions for me at Pragertopia.com. This is only available to Pragertopia Plus members. This is our chance to connect like never before. Go to Pragertopia.com or click the banner at DennisPrager.com.
Piedmont Triad area weather staying nice for the next couple of days. Mid-50s on the afternoon high today, and we should have plenty of sunshine. We have high pressure set up over the area. Getting a little breezy tonight, but still fair, clear, and mid-30s. And then we're in the upper 60s for the afternoon high on Wednesday. We get another sunny day. It will be a little bit windy. Not as windy on Thursday, sunny and low 60s. I'm meteorologist Steve Hamilton for News Talk Sports for the Triad, WSJS.
Honey, the garage door is making this weird noise.
Precision Garage Door, your local experts, they can spot these type of issues that you might not be able to see. Just like anything mechanical, your garage door might start making some noises, and you're better off finding out what is causing that noise. Precision Garage Door has free service calls with any repair. They can make your garage door run smoothly in a single day. Your garage door should make your life easier. Schedule your appointment today, precisiondoornc.com.
Yes, Josh Graham has opinions.
There is nothing that entertains the audience and the masses more than me being bothered.
And yes, he's got attitude.
Really, none of the game made sense to me.
And that's exactly why you love him.
When this all gets sorted out, I think you and me should get an apartment together.
You're on The Drive with Josh Graham.
You are on a Tuesday Drive. It is WSJS, News Talk Sports for the Triad, where the NCAA tournament opens up with the first half of the first four taking the floor tonight. Virginia will be representing the ACC. Both winners tonight will advance to Charlotte on Thursday, where we're going to be doing a morning show from ACC headquarters from 10 a.m. to noon. But we'll get to tonight's action shortly, because just before the show started, I filled out my bracket. It is completed. Rather than break down March Madness games one by one, or even going region by region, let's just fast forward to Glendale. Let's just fast forward to who's going to win it all. The North Carolina Tar Heels are going to win the national championship this year. Now, before anybody accuses me of being a homer, just pandering to my audience, our show is the longest running daily sports talk show in the history of the Triad. This is our sixth March Madness. Do you know how many times I picked Duke or Carolina to cut down nets? Zero. It hasn't happened. However, this year's different. But I can already feel some of you thinking, what about the NC State loss? Josh, if they can't win the ACC tournament against that team, how do you expect them to win the whole darn thing? There is historical precedent there. In the 64-team era of the NCAAs that dates back to 1985, the Tar Heels have won four national championships, 1993, 2005, 2009, and 2017. None of those teams won the ACC tournament. None of those four teams. And then they went on to win the national title.
Plus, a Carolina win would be fitting with the Final Four being in Phoenix. The last time the Final Four was there, Joel Berry, Justin Jackson and company beat Gonzaga and won the national title. Phoenix can be like what Indy is for Duke, or to a degree, what New Orleans has been for the Tar Heels. Carolina got the best draw of the one seeds. They got the one over Iowa State, even though Iowa State finished fourth in the final AP poll. The committee gave North Carolina that final one spot. They sent them to Charlotte. Arizona's the two. They're not going to make it to the Elite Eight. It's not going to be a North Carolina versus Caleb Love matchup. Last I checked, Arizona lost to a 15 seed last year. Also, their coach is a Gonzaga guy. Gonzaga, not exactly known for its toughness or advancing far in this tournament. Not a great draw for Arizona on the bottom side of that bracket. Baylor, they're down this year compared to the Carolina, the team that played Carolina in 2022 in that second round game in which Brady Manick got thrown out. RJ Davis went crazy. You might remember that game going to overtime. Alabama leaking oil as a four seed. It's a good draw. One seeds. If you're filling out your bracket, the smart thing to do is to pick a one seed to win the national title. 26 of the 44 champions since 1979 have been one seeds. So you might also be wondering, Josh, why not UConn? Here's why. There have been just two repeat national champions since David Thompson and company in 74 upended UCLA's seven straight national titles. Only twice have we seen a team, a school, win back-to-back championships. WD, can you name any one of them?
Florida did it.
2006, 2007. Florida was the last team to do it. Do you want to guess the other?
What conference are they in?
The Atlantic Coast Conference.
Oh.
91-92.
Duke.
That is correct. Give yourself a bell.
Thank you.
Belated happy birthday to WD2. Very good work on your part. The odds are against UConn. Also, UConn is in a bracket with 11 automatic qualifiers in it. They have the fourth-ranked team in the KenPom rankings getting a four seed in Auburn. It's not an easy path, but even if they do get to the Final Four, I like the fact that Carolina's already played UConn. Played them in their backyard. Played them tough, too. Carolina checks all the boxes you want for a national title team. So North Carolina is the pick. They are going to win the national championship. My other Final Four teams, UConn, Kentucky, and Creighton. So 2-1s, 2-3s, and North Carolina beating Creighton in the national championship game. You can reach out to the show on X at WSJS Radio or give us a call, 336-777-1600. Will Dalton, the executive producer of this show. Can I tell you something that frustrates me today, WD?
Yes, you can.
Rather than talk about Batman 1989, which you watched for the first time last night, and we'll break that down shortly, or even talking about the March Madness games this second, we've got to talk about another school suing the ACC today. By filing a lawsuit against the ACC in South Carolina this morning, Clemson is following Florida State's lead in challenging the grant of rights. They're starting the process of exploring an exit from the ACC.
Have a great day and go ACC.
The timing of this suit might be the most Clemson thing ever. You might as well say it's another form of Clemsoning, if you remember that. Except this version isn't the Tigers losing a game that they absolutely should win at an inopportune time. No, this version, the definition of it is doing something that showcases how little you care about anything that isn't football. That's this form of Clemson. Today's lawsuit is quintessential Clemson. They file this suit the day the NCAA tournament begins, an NCAA tournament that Clemson is in. They can't let Brad Brownell have any happiness a year after he's left out. Brad Brownell, you're in the tournament. So good. You're going to get all this shine. No, you're not. All anyone's going to talk about related to your team is what your athletic department's pulling right now and suing the league. Couldn't wait a week. Nope. Got to do it now. This tracks for the athletic department. Just Google former Clemson assistant Steve Smith and what happened to him. He was caught on a wiretap. That's why he was fired by the FBI. Did he do anything wrong? No. He just happened to say, truthfully, if they invested as much in basketball or even a little bit more in basketball the way they invest in football, Zion Williamson would be playing at Clemson. That was a capital offense at Clemson. No, not being caught on the wiretap. Criticizing football. You can't come back. Nobody questions Clemson football and Dabo Swinney and Tigerland. So why now? Why sue now? Two answers to that. Number one, we learned of the details of the 14-team college football playoff format last week, and Clemson deems itself, rightfully, as one of the top programs in college football. They will be playing in a conference, if they stay in the ACC, that has fewer bids to the NCAA, or pardon me, to the CFP, fewer annual automatic qualifying bids, and will be accepting less money. It's a lesser football conference. They are not cool with that. Jimmy Pitaro, ESPN's president, just announced in the last couple of hours, by the way, that the CFP will be exclusively broadcast on ESPN for the first 6 years of the 14-team format that starts in 2026. So that'll run through 2031. The second reason is the ACC has a hearing with FSU this Friday in Charlotte. This is going to apply more pressure on the ACC. Apply pressure to get a figure, to get a number on how to get out. And then you can figure it out from there, trying to shake free the trees. But this is the key difference between FSU's suit and Clemson's suit. Never once over the last 30 years, because partly Florida State would always remind us of this, has Florida State ever felt like a true member of the ACC. It's never really felt that way at all. They're always reminding everybody how elite they are in football and how they're different, and this is just a basketball conference, yada, yada, yada. Clemson is one of the founding members of the ACC. Been here for 71 years. They had representation in that smoke-filled room in Sedgefield to go all historical on you here. So the fact that they're doing this, and trying to do so in a more measured, quieter manner. They're not going to live stream any Board of Trustees meetings like the loons in Tallahassee have done. But they are applying pressure here, and they're looking for the same result that Florida State's looking for. Those two are aligned, as was made official today by this lawsuit being filed. WD's movie this week, Batman 1989. And Will, you want to get nuts? Come on! Let's get nuts! At the movies with the WD next.
Bend a knee to the Queen City. The crown belongs to Charlotte.
Cross into the area. Save made by Kalina. It goes to ground and covers it up.
Saturday night. After three straight road games, the boys in blue return to the bank for a date with the Columbus Crew. Live coverage starts at 7. First kick at 7:30.
It's a really important cutout by Christian Kalina there, collapsing down to his right-hand side, cutting out the delivery there.
Your home for the Charlotte Football Club is WSJS.
ZZ Top. Leonard Skinner. Two American institutions unite. The sharp-dressed Simple Man Tour. Friday, March 29th, Greensboro Coliseum. With Blackstone Cherry. On sale now at LiveNation.com. ZZ Top and Leonard Skinner live, presented by Live Nation.
Man, it is already time for March Madness. I tell you what, I'm just going to sit on my couch, watch basketball all day, and eat chicken wings from East Coast Wings and Grill. They cook up fresh jumbo wings with your choice of 50 different flavors. And don't forget, kids are going to be able to eat for $1.99 on Wednesdays with the purchase of an adult entree. That's dine-in only. So do me a favor, go support the companies that help bring you this live March Madness broadcast. Visit EastCoastWings.com. That's EastCoastWings.com.
It's Mac Moore, Budget Blinds of North Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, and Boone. In today's world, we're all concerned with safety and security. And for over 30 years, Budget Blinds has provided safety and security with style. Are your window coverings safe? Do they have loose, dangling cords that can strangle? Well, we can help make your home or workplace safer with cordless, motorized, and fire-rated window coverings. In today's world, we're also concerned with security. And again, enlightened style by Budget Blinds can help. From motorized shades to home automation, and even professional security or anti-graffiti window films that deter burglars, thieves, and vandals. So whether you need to make the inside of your home or business safer for loved ones or customers, or you need to make it tougher for the bad guys outside to wreak havoc, we can help. Schedule your free consultation today with one of our local design consultants and let us help make your home or office safer and more secure. Budget Blinds of North Winston-Salem, Mount Airy, and Boone, budgetblinds.com.
Riddle Tractor sells the good stuff. Skag Residential and Commercial Mowers will create and maintain the perfect lawn and landscape. Skag mowers are created to be tougher than anything you can throw at it and built for superior durability, productivity, and comfort. At Riddle Tractor, we sell the good stuff. Tractors, mowers, blowers, and more at Riddle Tractor in Winston-Salem, equipping those who get the job done. For more information, visit riddletractor.com.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time once again.
You're on the drive with Josh Graham.
We'll get to tonight's college basketball action shortly. Actually, before we get to At the Movies, let's just get to this now. Even as an underdog, Virginia is not losing to the Mountain West in the first four tonight. This is the ACC going all Michael Jordan meme, and I took that personally. For months, having yokels on television say the Mountain West is a better conference than the ACC. Well, here you go. Two first round matchups, or I guess first four in a first round matchup, where the ACC is facing the Mountain West. Virginia versus Colorado State tonight, Clemson facing New Mexico, and Vegas is telling you they think the Mountain West is better.
Send me that cash out, family.
Both the Mountain West teams are favored. Virginia isn't losing tonight. The national discourse surrounding the Cavaliers has gone way too far. They've been the team that national pundits tee off on. Not Colorado State, who was the last team in. Nope. They think Virginia doesn't deserve to be in. Where's your resume? 14 ACC wins. Florida and A&M out of conference. Since when is a double bye in the ACC winning 14 league games seen to be a negative, seen not to be a good enough resume? What planet are we on? Also, they should have been in the ACC championship game. If Tony Bennett decided to foul with the fouls he had to give, up three against Michael O'Connell and State, they win that game. And credit to Tony Bennett. When he got to Dayton yesterday, he admitted he made a mistake.
I believe I made a mistake at the end of the game. That we had two fouls. We had decided to not foul. We fouled a three-point shooter before, and then we had talked as a team and said, let's win it with our defense. And we got a stop with 5 seconds left, didn't foul. We were up three. Got the rebound, and Isaac went to the line. And, I was going to call a timeout, but I didn't want to ice him. But should have had, if I could do that over, should have had the guys at the line, and thinking about it now, maybe fouled on that spot because we had some to give.
A crispy Virginia team tonight. They hear all this stuff. They do. They're coming off a loss. It's the Mountain West. Just think about this. Take the 1,000-foot view for a moment. We're talking about the ACC against the Mountain West Conference.
Have a great day and go ACC.
No conference in the history of this tournament has been more successful than the ACC. Oh, Josh, don't cite ancient history. Okay. Since 2015, no team has more Final Four appearances. No team has more national championship. No conference, I should say, has more Final Four appearances. Elite Eight. Sweet 16, whatever metric you care to look at that says how good your team is in March. Nobody's better than the ACC. Short sample, long sample, whatever you care to look at. Since 2013, the Mountain West Conference's record in the tournament is 10-21. And if you think that sounds bad, consider half those wins belong to San Diego State last year. They won 5 tournament games last year, which means if you were just to eliminate San Diego State, who Virginia's not playing tonight, they're playing Colorado State. If you just take them away, since that run last year by San Diego State, you remove that, the Mountain West Conference would be 5-20 since 2013. Yet Colorado State is favored against Virginia tonight. Favored against a team that won 14 ACC games.
Send me that cash out, family.
Unreal. And New Mexico is favored against Clemson, too. Now, you might be thinking, Josh, that's a lot of bloviating. Get to the X's and O's. Sure. We know Virginia's pretty tough defensively, right? Are there many teams in the ACC that defend stylistically or play stylistically like Virginia does, WD?
No.
No. I'd say that's the definition of a pretty difficult scout. Especially, WD, when was Selection Sunday? When did they announce those brackets generally?
6 o'clock.
Yeah, 6:30. Like 6 o'clock. So they fly out yesterday to Dayton. They play tonight. It's barely a 2-day prep for Virginia for the pack the line. Oh, but Colorado State has a really good score. Okay. Virginia's seen a number of good scores. Have you heard of Reese Beekman? 2-time ACC Defensive Player of the Year? The Cavaliers control this game. They win comfortably tonight. Book that. Now let's get to At the Movies, Batman 1989 edition, with the WD.
Unless you're talking about Star Wars,
Obi-Wan has taught you well.
Movies aren't exactly Will's thing.
I don't get it.
You uncultured swine!
But that's about to change because Josh can't stand it anymore. This is At the Movies with Will Dalton.
What you liked, what you didn't like, best quote, Rotten Tomatoes. We wanted to do a DC movie. 3 of the 4 we put on the poll were Washington, DC movies. Then we did a DC comics movie, and of course that's the one that won because there's a lot of nerds out there. Batman 1989, what did you
down here? First of all, there's that one lady that towards the beginning of the movie when they held up the man and the woman, the thief or the burglar goes, "Don't scream."
That's right.
And then as soon as he leaves, what's the first thing she does?
Screams.
That was kind of funny. Also,
you liked that.
I thought it was funny.
Okay.
Also, Jack Nicholson was fantastic as the Joker.
Correct answer. Jack Nicholson.
He was made for it.
This is going to be, I don't want to get dark, but Jack's getting older. Like when Jack Nicholson one day passes away.
Yes.
This might be the first movie that's listed on the obituary. Now, let me be clear. I'm not saying it's his best movie. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Classic. The Shining.
Yep. Those are the three I think of.
Chinatown. Like, these are iconic. These are the best roles. But many, 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 many more people watched Batman than watched those other movies. I think this is what he's going to be most remembered for. This portrayal, even as Heath Ledger kind of ended all Joker portrayals by the way he played the Dark Knight, played the Joker in the Dark Knight, seeming to be the best Joker performance. What did you not like about this movie?
So I did, you asked me this a couple of times. I did like this movie. I did. But I noticed something, and we actually discussed this over the break a minute ago. It seemed dark for the time, 1989.
And quite literally, there were a lot of scenes that was just hard to see what was happening.
Yes. But it is quirky at times. Like, it seems
just
almost...
Just say the Prince songs. Like, when...
It seems comical at times.
Is it supposed to be scary when he's in the museum dancing around to Prince?
Yeah, like it...
That's just... And you watch it, it doesn't fit. It's very 80s. I thought at the time maybe that was scary and how it was supposed to be. Apparently, Tim Burton is quoted saying, "Nah, even at the time, I hated how the Prince songs were shoehorned in there." The Prince song playing again with the parade later. It really, the thing that doesn't fit the most, the thing that ages this movie the most, the worst part about it is the Prince songs. Also, the way that this movie marketed things is kind of the model for how movies are done now, the last decade, the 2010s, where everything has to be, everybody has to have a cape and everything has to have merchandise or whatever.
Yep.
It kind of ruined movies in the 2010s, which I don't like very much because I'm not a big superhero movie guy. But yeah, the Prince songs probably boil it all down to what doesn't age well.
And Batman's like, it just, his movement, again, back to the comic, his movements are so quirky. In
the suit is really cool, though.
The suit's fantastic.
Probably the best Batman suit. That's a great suit.
I like the Nolan suit.
Best quote.
Can you pass the salt?
Really?
I mean, it's because it's also, do I look like I'm joking?
Uh-huh.
That's something.
There are a lot of Joker lines to pick from. These are the most iconic, obviously, is wait till they get a load of me.
Yeah.
But my favorite line, this is my personal favorite. The line, every time I hear it, makes me laugh when I hear the way that Jack Nicholson read the line. He stole my balloons!
See, I didn't want to go with the Joker line because...
He stole my balloons!
I did enjoy that scene where they were at dinner. And
I'm stunned. What you liked wasn't just two words. Those words being, or three words, Billy D. Williams.
Huh?
I was expecting Billy D. Williams to be the three words for you liked.
I did have this written down, but we moved along. So shout out to Lando Calrissian.
Calrissian?
Yeah.
Rotten Tomatoes score at the movies. Batman 1989. Can you get within five?
This one seems tricky. 83.
Man, you're getting good at this. 84%.
Aha!
And that's been At the Movies with the WD.
I'm Batman. It's so stupid.
Credit to Tim Burton and for Michael Keaton. It's not stupid.
It's just
every
funny.
Other Batman movie has stolen from that.
So is that where it started?
I mean, this is the first Batman movie. Like, Adam West certainly didn't do that with the TV show. Like, him doing a lower voice is something that every movie has taken from. So whether that's Keaton, Tim Burton, or whomever, that is a huge win as well for this movie. This is a question everyone's asked since Saturday night. Okay, you won the ACC tournament. State, what can you do in the NCAAs? Do you have anything left in the tank? We'll discuss next on The Drive.
City Barbecue's motto is slow and low, baby. Their pitmasters use hickory, years of experience, and all 24 hours to craft the city's best barbecue. Pulled pork, tender beef, brisket, all off the bone ribs, juicy smoked chicken, turkey, and sausage. City Barbecue's selection of sauces is awesome. Pick your favorite region and sauce up your barbecue. And don't get me started on their made-from-scratch fixins and desserts. Go to City Barbecue today on Jonestown Road in Winston-Salem. Slow and low, baby. Slow and low.
Join the Carolina Corps for the Cup. The 2024 U.S. Open Cup match will be played this Thursday, 7:30, at the UNCG Soccer Stadium in Greensboro. To purchase tickets for the Cup, learn more about how you can become part of the Carolina Corps, the latest team news, player updates, and events, or become a season ticket holder. Visit CarolinaCorpsFC.com.
This is an SRNU special report. I'm John Scott. SB4 can be enforced. A divided U.S. Supreme Court decision has lifted a stay on a Texas law that gives police broad powers to arrest migrants that are suspected of crossing the U.S.-Mexico border illegally, while a legal battle over immigration authority plays out. This law allows any police officer in Texas to arrest migrants for illegal entry. A judge could then order them to leave the U.S. Texas argued it has a right to take action over what authorities have called a crisis at the southern border. The Biden administration is suing to strike down the measure, arguing it's a violation of federal authority that would hurt international relations and create chaos in administering immigration law. Governor Greg Abbott called the situation an invasion of migrants. This has been an SRNU special report. I'm John Scott.
This is Dennis Prager. I am excited to announce the all-new Pragertopia Plus.
You can listen to my show whenever it's convenient for you, all commercial free and all on demand. Now with Prager Plus, search topics, guests, and segments all the way back to 2010. And now a truly exciting new benefit, my monthly online video get-together for Pragertopia Plus members only. This is where for an hour each month, Pragertopia Plus members get an exclusive chance to ask me anything. That's right, anything. It's on video. I'll be talking to you and answering your questions. We may even have a special guest every now and then. I've never done this. Submit your questions for me at Pragertopia.com. This is only available to Pragertopia Plus members. This is our chance to connect like never before. Go to Pragertopia.com or click the banner at DennisPrager.com.
With SRN Sports, I'm Jeremy House. In the NBA, the Philadelphia 76ers regained control late in the fourth quarter for a key Eastern Conference win over the Miami Heat.
The 76ers pulled away the fourth quarter for a 98-91 win over the Heat. Up by 14 the start of the quarter, Philadelphia saw Miami rally to tie the game at 85. They retook the lead for good on a three-point basket by Buddy Hield and got key baskets by Kyle Lowry that preserved the win.
Got some shots that went in, and we were patient and we were poised.
Tyrese Maxey had a game-high 30 for the Sixers, who moved into the sixth spot of the Eastern Conference standings.
I feel like guys are, you know, coming back or whatever, and we need to be stepping in the right direction come playoff time.
Bam Adebayo and Mike Rozier had 20 for Miami. Michael Luongo, Philadelphia.
Other winners included Cleveland, Boston, Chicago, Minnesota, New York, the LA Lakers, and Sacramento. This is SRN Sports.
Piedmont Triad area weather staying nice for the next couple of days. Mid-50s on the afternoon high today, and we should have plenty of sunshine. We have high pressure set up over the area. Getting a little breezy tonight, but still fair, clear, and mid-30s. And then we're in the upper 60s for the afternoon high on Wednesday. We get another sunny day. It will be a little bit windy. Not as windy on Thursday, sunny and low 60s. I'm meteorologist Steve Hamilton for News Talk Sports for the Triad, WSJS.
If you own your home or you're about to own your dream home, Heritage Hardwood Floors can do nearly anything, anywhere, in any style. They do hardwood, waterproof laminates, carpets, and gym floors. Well, whatever you can dream of. Here's the thing. Most homeowners don't know what's available and what's current. So please do this. See Jesse or Catherine at Heritage Hardwood Floors and see what the great fuss is all about. Find them online. Heritage Hardwood Floors. They have no ceiling. Heritage Hardwood Floors.
It's the Drive with Josh Graham, WSJS.
Really is a big hoops night. The Charlotte Hornets, they play in Orlando. Speaking of the Hornets, Greensboro Swarm coach Jordan Surenkamp will be our guest in about 10 minutes or so. He'll have, we'll give away basketball tickets when he drops by. Tough draw for Charlotte tonight. Tough spot for Charlotte in Orlando. Elsewhere tonight, the T-Wolves play on back-to-back nights. They've got the Denver Nuggets. Both are half a game back of the number one spot in the Western Conference. Which dunk was better last night?
Oh,
Anthony Edwards against John Collins, or was it John Collins' former team and former Duke Blue Devil, Jalen Johnson, dunking over Austin Reeves? Did you see that one?
Yeah, I saw Austin Reeves talking about that one after the game.
RIP, former Deke, John Collins.
It's got to be the Anthony Edwards. I mean, that was just, whoa.
Tough. The first four starts tonight, in addition to UVA beating Colorado State. You've got Wagner Howard tonight. Winner of that game gets North Carolina in Charlotte. If Virginia, when Virginia wins, they'll face the Texas Longhorns in a 7-10 in Charlotte as well. The NIT tips off tonight. Richmond at Virginia Tech. That's a fun regional game. Same for Boston College playing at Providence.
Boston College.
The winner of Xavier, Georgia tonight. Could play in Winston-Salem this weekend. That's dependent on if Wake can take care of App State tomorrow. We will be doing our show live from the Joel tomorrow from 3 to 6. And then morning shows Thursday, Friday.
10 a.m. to noon, getting you set for NCAA tournament action throughout the day on WSJS. Thursday, we'll be in Charlotte at ACC headquarters uptown. 336-777-1600 if you want in. Let's go to Joey in Thomasville. Joey, happy March. Really March in earnest, even though today is March the 19th. The NCAA tournament tips off with the first four tonight. What do you have for me?
Josh, I tell you what, man, this is one of my favorite times of the year. No matter where I've worked over the course of my working career, I have always taken off Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday to watch this first round of the NCAA tournament. I love it. I wasn't able to get in yesterday, so you certainly know me as a Carolina fan. A lot of people do. I wanted, you know, just give props to NC State. That was a heck of a run. I give them all the credit in the world. I mean, they just played a heck of a game, and we didn't have any answers for them in the championship game. Kudos to them. I've never been myself personally a State hater. I actually like State. I pull for State often when they're not playing us, so I wish them well in the tournament. What an amazing run. Now, that being said, your earlier segment, I love what you said because, brother, we're on the same wavelength when it comes to some money.
The Tar Heels are my pick to win the national championship. So I sound like you're in agreement.
Too. I got some money on them to win it.
Hey, JC Horn.
I've also got some money on the ACC being the conference with the most wins in the NCAA.
Oh.
So I liked all the stats that you gave. That's hey, anybody looking for some good odds? That's some good odds. Go for it right there. And then my last bet, I took Virginia, just like you were talking about.
So cash up,
same wavelength, man. We're thinking the same. I'm looking forward to a fun tournament. It's always a blast. It's great. Buzzer beaters, upsets, watching your brackets. It's no better time of year, well, except for baseball season. But anyway.
Yeah. Thank you, Joey. Appreciate that. Did we just become best friends? Pretty good stuff there. Same wavelength. You mentioned the pack from Saturday. Ever since the Syracuse second round game, where they won by 18, I just suspended any forecasting of what the pack is capable of doing. And you should follow suit. You should not write off the Wolfpack. The 1983 vibes, they are uncanny. Rewatched Survive in Advance, as I do every year before the tournament starts a couple nights back. Strongly recommend that. WD, was last night a read a book night? Oh, wait, you watched Batman. It was your birthday.
I watched Batman.
I watched the Taylor Swift Eras Tour.
How was that?
I didn't realize it was 3.5 hours, so I was up till like 1 in the morning, but was it had good? It on in the background. Yeah.
Or is that a dumb question?
Very dumb question. We're talking about Taylor Swift here. Come on. Yeah. But the ACC tournament run that they went on in 83, shocking, amazing. So it was last week, 5 games in 5 days. Michael O'Connell beating Carolina at the end. It's even crazier than that. And just imagine if Twitter existed back in 83, what people would be saying. They probably wouldn't be picking that team to win the NCAA tournament, especially against Houston in the final. There is recent evidence that says that teams barely getting in can make runs. UCLA, from the first four in or the last four in to the final four, that was in 2020. You had Carolina, obviously, barely getting in 2022. They get to the national title game. The best example of this was the only other team in college basketball history to win 5 conference tournament games in 5 days, the 2011 UConn Huskies, who went on to win the national championship. The Pack didn't get a bad draw. Texas Tech, so-so 60. Nothing's a given, but that wasn't the worst draw for NC State to get. And if they win that game, they likely get Kentucky in round two. Who has had, among the big dogs in college basketball, less success in March of late than Kentucky has? Kentucky didn't get out of Greensboro last year.
Nope.
The year before that, they lost to St. Peter's in round one. Kentucky's been having some issues now. Much like State, Kentucky doesn't play a lot of defense. Or at least with State, they don't play much defense in the post. Casey Morsell certainly does. I don't think it's a bad matchup for State. I think it's going to be a great game. I think that game's a toss-up. I really do. NC State, Kentucky, if we were to get there, and you have the fun Rob Dillingham angle to that as well. Regardless of what happens, let's say State loses to Texas Tech, gets beat by 20, regardless of what happens, this team's going to be beloved. DJ Burns is going to go down as a state legend. And when we talk about modern day NC State legends, football, basketball, women's hoops, baseball, what's that list? I mean, for football, it's Phillip Rivers, it's Russell Wilson when he was there. You had those great quarterbacks rolling through. For NC State basketball, it's been TJ Warren in the last 10 to 12 years. And you then go back to Julius Hodge, probably. So DJ Burns, TJ Warren, Julius Hodge, that's the class DJ Burns shares now. And you can't overstate how significant that win was for the Pack, how it might change local dynamics between fans, how it might change the outlook of the Pack. Obviously, saving Kevin Keats's job. You can't overstate how important that was for the Pack. Simply can't. Is the amount of impact your local YMCA has on the local community. And they do really neat things, such as Warrior Sports. If you're unaware of this, it's a relatively new program. They've done basketball, they've done soccer, now basketball back for a second season. It's boys and girls ages 8 to 13 that have disabilities. It gives them a place to learn the fundamentals and other important aspects of youth sports, such as character building, teamwork, sportsmanship, and mindset. Space is limited, though, so get on it if you haven't already. Open till the end of March or until it fills up. It's available at Jerry Long. www.ymcanwnc.org is where you go to sign up. The head coach of the Greensboro Swarm, the Hornets G League affiliate here, is Jordan Surenkamp. And he's telling me he has bracket picks to share. So we'll get that from a pro basketball perspective. And we have basketball tickets to give away when Jordan joins us next.
Wake up with the morning show. When you get out of your bed, you'll be raring to go.
Coming up on the next Triad Today, Steve Alford from the University of North Carolina School of the Arts. We'll get online with Chase Vaden. We'll go on the road again. Susie will be here with This Week in Carolina History and another edition of Helping Hands. Don't miss me. I'm Jeffrey and Christian Snyder on the next Triad Today. Bye-bye.
Honey, we should...
Wallet cringes, U.S. Cabinet Express in High Point has the solution. How? They're going to take the complication out of buying kitchen and bathroom cabinets with a free design consultation and a price breakdown for all cabinetry. Plus,
top working condition in your family safe. Precision Garage Door offers free service calls with any type of repair. So relax and make life easier. Visit PrecisionDoorNC.com today. PrecisionDoorNC.com.
Calling all athletic maintenance and facility directors. Heritage Hardwood Floors in Winston-Salem can provide you with multiple gym floor services. From installing new hardwood, sanding and finishing existing hardwoods, logo layout and design to your annual maintenance coating. Heritage is Horner, Bona, and Hub certified, and summer scheduling, it's already begun. So visit HeritageHardwoodFloors.ws. They also do residential flooring projects as well. Don't forget, Heritage Hardwood Floors, when it comes to flooring, they have no ceiling. HeritageHardwoodFloors.ws.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for.
You're on the drive with Josh Graham.
Somehow, some way, this weekend, the final homestand of the Greensboro Swarm's season, Friday and Saturday at the Fieldhouse, Get your tickets now. 336-777-1600. First couple to call in, get tickets to the Swarm this weekend, or you can get your tickets at gsoswarm.com. We're now being joined by the head coach of the Swarm, Jordan Surenkamp, who had a homework assignment last week. We asked him to fill out a bracket, even though he's entrenched in a season and not watching a lot of college hoops. He has done that for us. So let's cut to the chase. Who is in your final four before we get to the national championship?
So like I was saying, I've been doing my research. I probably watched 5 total college basketball games this year, and 4 of them were probably this past weekend with the conference tournament. I'm making sure I have this correct. Okay. I'm going to go UConn, Arizona, which is going to anger a lot of people, I'm sure, Kentucky, and Purdue. Those are my 4.
I am in agreement on 2 of those. UConn and Kentucky are also in my final 4. I have North Carolina winning the national championship. Who do you have winning the championship? And for those, by the way, we mentioned this earlier, for those think I'm pandering to people, I've been doing this show. This is my 6th NCAA tournament doing this show. This is the first time I think I've ever picked Carolina in a bracket. First time ever. So this is not like a pandering deal. I just think Carolina's going to win it. Who do you think's going to win it?
I have UConn winning. I just think they're as deep as anybody. So, but when I picked these as well, this is just me being the coach that I am. I'm way more probably offensive minded than I should be. I just think that really good guard play gets you really far in the tournament.
Tell me if you're breaking any rules by doing this. Tell me if this is something you can do. Do you know guys on UConn? Are you like, oh man, if possible, I'd love to have this guy playing on my basketball team?
I mean, you watch and you're like, man, I love this guy's game. And you can say that about everybody across the country. It's not just for UConn. One of our assistant coaches, Danielle Marshall, is obviously a UConn great. So
Danielle Marshall's on staff. Didn't know that.
Yeah, Danielle Marshall's on staff. He's been with me for 3 years, and he was just voted one of like the top UConn players of all time, obviously. So I get a lot of just bickering from him throughout the college year because he watches and follows UConn religiously. So I probably am a little bit biased when it comes to that, but I probably watched, you know, I watched the Big East championship game. So like you said, like you watch a little bit and you get a little bit of bias based on who you watch too. So I just think they're super solid and they defend and they run good stuff offensively.
Get your tickets, gsoswarm.com, last homestand of the year, Friday and Saturday at the Fieldhouse. Biggest upset on Jordan Surenkamp's bracket?
Yeah, so I am going Samford over Kansas, opening round.
We're in agreement.
I love it. Obviously, the injuries for Kansas hurts.
Yep.
But I've done enough research to know that the pace of play that Samford plays with, and they're at altitude, and they play 10 deep, and Kansas great usually conference. Goes like 7. So good.
Great conference they play in too. So I really like that. I have another 13 seed getting actually not just through the first round to the second round. I'm looking at Charleston to, I think Alabama's leaking oil. I don't think things are going well right now down the stretch, blown out by Florida, not once, but twice in the last few weeks. And then pairing them potentially with St. Mary's, I think that's a good matchup for Charleston too. So there's a chance North Carolina could be playing Charleston in the Sweet 16 out in Los Angeles.
It's a pretty good one as well. I mean, there's a ton of these potential ones across the board. I like Creighton. I think Creighton has a chance. I think Kentucky more than anybody probably has as favorable of a matchup scale as you can get. It could be, and I see a McNeese and Samford second round coming. So I'm looking forward to that.
Got to ask this, bringing it back to your team, but still relating it to March a little bit. Since the Tar Heels are in Charlotte Thursday, Saturday, does Leaky Black get an excused absence from practice?
You know, he does not, unfortunately. We talked about this the other day, too. The 2:45 tip hurts. I was hoping it was going to be a little bit later on. I was going to try to make the drive back here in time for the game. I know that Leaky and I both talked about going to the game, but that was before they put the times out. And now, if for whatever reason he's not there at the start of practice, I'll know where he is, but it's not excused.
What's the system look like? Does Leaky Black like have like an out saying, hey, I got to run X amount of sprints if I miss practice? Or is there a fine system? How does this work?
Oh, it's definitely a fine system. When you get to the professional basketball, you hit them where it hurts, and it's in the money. It's with the pocket. So, yeah, if you guys are watching and he's sitting courtside next to Roy Williams at that first Carolina game, everybody will know he's in the wrong.
If we see Leaky Thursday, because we'll be there. If we see Leaky Thursday, we're going to start a GoFundMe for Leaky Black.
That would be great. I'm sure it would well receive from all the Carolina faithful and everybody that loves him. Being a local guy.
Jordan Surenkamp's going to be mad at me next week. Like, oh, did you really do this? I think you're enabling him a little bit. Jordan, best of luck Friday and Saturday. Again, get your swarm tickets. In fact, give us a call now, 336-777-1600. Let's give away another pair of tickets to go see the Swarm Friday, Saturday out at the Fieldhouse. It's crazy to think we're getting close to the end of the year, but best of luck this week, Coach, and we'll talk to you next week.
Thank you. Looking forward to it.
Got it. Jordan Surenkamp, kind enough to be here, 336-777-1600 if you want to watch some basketball at the Fieldhouse this weekend. There is so much happening right now. Some college basketball news to pass along. WD, you're familiar with the requirements in the rafters to get your name and number honored at the Smith Center. One of them is ACC Player of the Year, RJ Davis, already done that.
Mm-hmm.
Another is being first or second team All-American. And the AP just announced RJ Davis, first team All-American.
Saw that.
Did I?
Caleb Love, third team, apparently.
Hmm. So, for the first time since Joel Berry and Justin Jackson had their numbers put into the rafters, it'll be RJ Davis at some point and probably Armando Bacot as well, if they can make an exception for him. And I think they should, when he owns the rebounding record. I think that's a nice compromise that you can have to try and get that done. Put Kennedy Meeks up there while you're at it. One of the requirements is most outstanding player in the Final Four. If the voting didn't end as early as it did for that, then Kennedy Meeks, given what he did in the title game, would have won that award. So I do think that eventually he should go up there as well. The other bit of college news. So Clemson, they're suing to get out of the ACC. They won't say it's as clear as that, but they're following suit with what Florida State's done. And we have a statement now from Jim Ryan, who's the chair of the ACC Board of Directors and ACC Commissioner Jim Phillips, in the last 10 minutes. Quote, the ACC remains confident that its agreements with all its members will be affirmed by the courts. Clemson, along with all ACC members, voluntarily signed and re-signed the 2013 and 2016 grant of rights, which is binding through 2036. In addition, Clemson agreed to the process and procedures for withdrawal. Conference's legal counsel will vigorously enforce the agreement and bylaws in the best interest of the ACC's current and incoming members. Do find it interesting what ESPN thinks of this, because we learned via Florida State's court filings that ESPN has an out after 2025. So what happens if ESPN says, you know what, we're good through 2036. This contract no longer is necessary. And that allows Clemson and Florida State to jump and others to jump with the ACC.
Interesting.
They just agreed to a college football playoff extension of their contract 2026 to 2031 earlier today. You know a great place to watch March Madness games? BJ's Brewhouse and Restaurant. We were telling you, unofficial home of the ACC viewing guide last week, ACC tournament. How about the big dance as well? Best place to watch the games, man. Love their wangs. Big fan of their work. The Pazookies, great desserts. Beer selection is plentiful. Massive TVs. WD and I were watching the college football playoff national championship there with many of you. And it's a great location at Haynes Mall. Go to their website to check out their menu, bjsrestaurant.com. Got to find your spot for NCAA tournament action. Oh, the Carolina Hurricanes. They have a lot. There's quite a bit happening with the Canes. They are at the Islanders tonight, riding a three-game winning streak. The Islanders are pretty good, but this is kind of a crazy stat. Carolina has won five straight road games. They've collected at least a point in eight straight road games. I think they won seven of those. Then you look at it today. Do you see what they revealed? Their new alternate jerseys.
Oh.
They revealed today. And it has the walking pig, the walking Stormy on the side of the jersey as one of the shoulder patches, which is pretty cool.
That's really cool. I like that.
Have you seen it?
No, I need to go take a look.
Yeah, you got to check it out real quick because the Stadium Series jerseys were fine. Didn't have any problem with them. I really like these, and it's hard for me to really explain why, short of the color's great, it's red, it's bright. You have the walking pig, the walking Stormy on the side.
I like that.
Pretty cool.
I like the retro C on the front.
The retro C is on the front. It's really cool.
Yeah.
And the new pieces for the Canes, they fit in nicely. Jake Guentzel had his first goal as a Cane against Ottawa, had the shootout winner in Toronto. Evgeny Kuznetsov has 5 points in the last three games, two of them being goals. And Freddie Anderson, since returning, 4-0 in starts. He's allowed 5 goals in those 4 starts. So Carolina clicking on all cylinders, aside from that 1-0 loss to the Rangers last week on home ice. Carolina in a really good spot right now. As are we, 1 hour through with today's show. Hour two will feature us selecting WD's movies for next week for you to vote on our social media platforms. Will Pelagic, his weekly visit, voice of Charlotte FC, and later on, Hayes Permar. Going to join us to play a special edition of Skips or Plays with Hayes. Hour two, 4 o'clock hour starts with the Big Four. Next.
Your pipe and slippers set out for you. I know you think that it ain't too far.
It's opening week at the Snake Pit. That's right. The Carolina Cobras' first home game is this Sunday at the Greensboro Coliseum. Coming off their first win, it's Cobras Military Appreciation Night with a post-game jersey auction on camouflage jerseys worn by the Cobras, along with Venom Dance Team military posters and military t-shirts. Get your tickets today as we honor local military personnel this Sunday. For tickets, slither on over to CarolinaCobras.com. That's CarolinaCobras.com.
Sick and tired of being sick and tired all the time? I sure was. I'm Stu Epperson, president of the Truth Network and host of Truth Talk Live. And that's why I'm so glad that for over a decade, I have been taking 4 Mighty Muscadine capsules every day. I can count on one hand the number of times I've been sick in that period of time. I'm still playing full court basketball into my 50s. Why? The Muscadine grape is power packed with all kinds of antioxidants. And Mighty Muscadine does not sell the fizzle and the sizzle. They sell the science. This product has been tested at a major medical university with remarkable results. Find out for yourself. Your body will love Mighty Muscadine. Order the capsules, which is what I take every day, or check out all their products, the Vine-tastic, the energy shots, the delicious Muscadine juice. All the lotions and things are there at the website, MightyMuscadine.com. Enter promo code TRUTH for extra savings. MightyMuscadine.com, promo code TRUTH.
The only station you need for news, talk, and sports. WSJS Winston-Salem, Greensboro, High Point, Burlington. Online at WSJS.com.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm John Scott. A divided Supreme Court lifting a stay on a Texas law that gives police broad powers to arrest migrants suspected of crossing the border illegally, while a legal battle over immigration authority plays out. Texas has argued it has the right to take action over what Governor Greg Abbott has described as an invasion of migrants on the border. Opponents have called the law known as Senate Bill 4 the most dramatic attempt by a state to police immigration since an Arizona law more than a decade ago, portions of which were struck down by the Supreme Court. Former President Trump says if he's reelected, he'll make America great again.
We're not a great country right now. We're left at all over the world. We owe $35 trillion. The whole thing is crazy. We are nuts.
The former president told the Salem Radio Network Sebastian Gorka
under his leadership, the U.S. will once again have a strong southern border and that the U.S. military will never go woke. Also at townhall.com, Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin says the international community must not let Ukraine fall.
Today, Ukraine's survival is in danger. And America's security is at risk. And they don't have a day to waste, and we don't have a day to spare either. So I leave here today fully determined to keep U.S. security assistance and ammunition flowing. And that's a matter of survival and sovereignty for Ukraine. And it's a matter of honor and security for America.
Austin addressing more than 50 defense leaders from Europe at Ramstein Air Base in Germany. On Wall Street, stocks finished higher. The Dow was up 320 points. The NASDAQ gained 63. More at townhall.com.
Hi, this is Rhett Rasmussen of besthotgrill.com. We make the Solaire infrared grills, which are unique among gas grills. We designed Solaire from the ground up to optimize the performance of the Solaire infrared burner. What is infrared? The Solaire infrared burner efficiently uses natural gas or propane, creating up to 15,000 tiny flames to heat the ceramic plate, which radiates the red hot intense heat directly to your food. Conventional gas grills heat the air inside the grill, which dries out the food. The direct Solaire infrared energy locks in the juices for a more natural tasting, succulent, and flavorful food. Diehard charcoal grillers agree that Solaire infrared is as close to the white hot intensity and taste they get from their charcoal fire, but with the convenience and controllability of gas. Solaire is truly the last grill you'll ever buy. Learn more at besthotgrill.com. That's besthotgrill.com. Solaire infrared at besthotgrill.com.
Piedmont Triad area weather staying nice for the next couple of days. Mid-50s on the afternoon high today, and we should have plenty of sunshine. We have high pressure set up over the area. Getting a little breezy tonight, but still fair, clear, and mid-30s. And then we're in the upper 60s for the afternoon high on Wednesday. We get another sunny day. It will be a little bit windy. Not as windy on Thursday, sunny and low 60s. I'm meteorologist Steve Hamilton for News Talk Sports for the Triad, WSJS.
Get ready to fly like a pilot. Stone Temple Pilots to Red Hat Amphitheater in Raleigh, September 1st. With special guests, Live and Soul Asylum. Presented by Live Nation. Tickets can be bought on both Live Nation and WSJS.com. And tickets can be won on WSJS.
You're on the drive with Josh Graham, WSJS.
Sailing with the pilot for the sea.
The big four.
Boy, the big four.
The big four.
Four. That's a big ten.
Boy. There we go.
The Big Four, brought to you by Budget Blinds of North Winston-Salem and Mount Airy. Serving Northern Forsyth, Stokes, and Surrey counties. Online at budgetblinds.com.
The Big Four, brought to you by
Budget Blinds.
Sponsoring this reset, where we tell you what's happening in sports right now. Quite a bit going on today. Budget Blinds online, budgetblinds.com, where you could learn about their in-home consultations, their inventory, shades, shutters, blinds, drapes, you name it. They've got you taken care of. What's number four on the Big Four today?
There's a couple of notable NFL signings today. Josh Dobbs is no longer on the market. Remember, he was with the Vikings. He is now going to be the backup in San Francisco after Sam Darnold is going to be the starter in Minnesota. So that's interesting. And then you also had the Cleveland Browns. They picked up Jerry Jeudy a couple of weeks ago. They have now signed him to a three-year extension. The financial terms were not disclosed, but they're saying that the deal is worth about $58 million, including 41 of that guaranteed. And then the Bengals trying to secure up their offensive line a little bit as they signed veteran offensive tackle Trent Brown to a one-year deal, trying to protect Joe Shiesty.
They're correct. Prioritize that over
yeah.
signing T. Higgins to some long-term extension. T. Higgins asking for a trade. Okay. okay, we'll see if they get anything back for T. Higgins or they have him play on that franchise tag. But this is where the money should be going for Cincinnati. As for the receiver conversation, some Panther fans are saying, why couldn't we have signed Jerry Jeudy? Panthers had been in talks with Mike Williams, and apparently Mike Williams is going to visit Pittsburgh tomorrow. Today, meeting with the Panthers, the former Clemson receiver, the former LA Chargers receiver, meeting with Carolina. Worth keeping an eye on what might happen there in the next couple of days. Number three on the Big Four is...
You know, it's really a big day for college basketball because the action starts today.
The action is the juice.
The action is the juice. So you've got...
Can you name what movie that's from?
Oh, you've that's... I know I have. That's...
Give me all you got!
Heat.
There you go.
Heat.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go, WD. So you answered a historical question,
dude,
right? You
I'm
answer
on
a
it.
Movie question, right? Who is this person today?
I don't know.
28-year-old WD.
I'm 28.
He's thriving.
I don't know what to do with my hands. Why do I feel this way? So tonight, the action starts. Wagner and Howard playing in the first four action. The winner of this one faces Carolina in the first round. And then Colorado State and Virginia. ACC action today for sure.
Give me the Hoos. Give me Virginia. Like, we'll do best bets later.
That's right.
I can promise you. Can promise you that Virginia will be making an appearance on that. And it's not going to be plus the 2.5. I saw it get up to 3 points some places. No, no, no. Money line with the Hoos. Number two on the Big Four is...
Oh, boy. Here we go again. We thought that Florida State... trying to get out of the league by suing could set a precedent and start a domino effect. And today is kind of an example of that, as now Clemson has filed a lawsuit in Pickens County, South Carolina, calling into question both the ACC's grant of right and exit fees, calling the withdrawal penalty, quote, unconscionable and unenforceable. Just a mess for the league and Jim Phillips right now.
Yeah, well, the ACC, like, if you want to sum this up to the layman, this is what I have. This is a layman's way of putting it. Florida State and Clemson are essentially saying, yes, we signed a contract 8 years ago in 2016 to sell you our house, to use that analogy. I think Stuart Mandel was making this analogy as well for The Athletic. Today... we think we could get a much better deal for our house, so you have to give us back our house. That's what Florida State and Clemson are essentially saying right now. These things that we signed and that bind everybody in the SEC and the Big Ten, and nobody violates these agreements, and that's why movement only happens at the end of these TV deals, they just don't apply to us. Why? Because, come on. Come on, like, it shouldn't, right? We could get a better deal. That's essentially what this is. And the ACC probably isn't going to budge. We'll see how it ends up shaking out. In court, no one's ever tried testing the grant of rights the way that FSU and Clemson are trying to do right now. But it is the most Clemson thing ever to do this today. The tournament starts in a week that Clemson is in the tournament. They missed out last year, and now everyone's talking about Clemson Tiger basketball, Brad Brownell. And now, like, I bet you if you turned on Clemson radio right now, our guys, like, oh, our guy, William Quackenbush, I bet you he hasn't talked anything about Clemson basketball today. It's just this.
Probably not.
For hours. And you're the reason that happened, Clemson. And again, you care about nothing other than football. We understand where your priorities are at. And number one on the Big Four, brought to you by
Budget Blind,
is
a man has been banned from Buc-ee's for life.
Still haven't been to Buc-ee's.
And this isn't Buc-ee's as in Starbucks. This is
no, like the actual place that's called Buc-ee's. No one calls Starbucks
apparently
Buc-ee's.
Apparently, I'm the only one that does that.
Because there's an actual restaurant or like convenience store called Buc-ee's.
Huh.
Apparently, there's one in South Carolina.
Okay, I had heard that, so that sounds right. Well, this man was banned from all Bucky's stores, regardless of where they are, for life, after bringing his service duck into the chain's Tennessee store. So this man, Justin Wood, he posted a video of the incident to his YouTube account. His YouTube channel is named Seductive. Because apparently, and it's got close to 3 million followers, and what he does is essentially he brings his service duck into various locations. He's got viral videos, including going into a Subway, a Chuck E. Cheese, a Hooters. Oh, I bet the duck was a big hit at Hooters. It had to have been.
Oh, yeah.
So this video shows him bringing his duck into the store, and they basically tell him that pets aren't allowed in the store. Well, he tries to explain to them, hey, this is a service animal. This is a service duck. He's like, I can give you three forms of identification right now if you like. And apparently they were not having it, and he made a whole big deal about it. And yeah, it got kind of ugly. And so now my guy can't shop at Bucky's anymore because of his duck, apparently.
When I was at Costco last night, I did see someone with the service dog there. And
oh,
I just wondered,
so cute.
Like, maybe how much does it cost to buy like a service dog, like a harness that says service dog on it, so I can take Willow the dog wherever I want. That, like, I'm not saying this person's service dog wasn't legit, but
yeah,
I'm sure they sell those things and nobody's checking. I mean, the Costco people, they are great at checking items and such. Yes. I don't think they're checking the legitimacy of the service dog. Probably not.
Probably not. You should
now,
do that,
to
though.
Be clear,
I would love to see this.
To be clear, I would never do that.
Yeah, it kind of sounds a little messed up.
I would never do that.
Exploit Willow the dog like that?
Exploit Willow? That'd be exploiting Costco, not Willow.
That's fair.
Willow would be happy to
play along,
run around
this
in Costco. But she'd probably poop in the Costco.
You think she would?
Every time she goes to Lowe's, she thinks that's grounds for number two.
Do you take her to Lowe's a lot?
Sarah Bradford does, and they make Willow sit in the cart after she takes care of her business.
That's what she stands on.
That's been the big four for today. I was waiting for Gary Hahn to tell me when to move on from that conversation, but he never showed up. Hey, I think you need an update.
Let's go to the sidelines, Tony Haynes.
You might need an update on your computer, perhaps.
Let's go to the sidelines, Tony Haynes.
Love that.
I'm smiling ear to ear right now because Jackson Holliday just hit a rope. Just hit a rope to shortstop, like a regular routine ground ball, but it was hit sharply. Beat out the throw. Regular ground ball to short. Beat out the throw.
Can't wait for O's games during the show.
Very soon.
It's gonna
like
be
a
fun
week and a half.
Let's go.
And we're there. Coming up, we pick WD's movies for next week, and we present the case for not filling out a bracket this year here on a Tuesday Drive.
WSJS knows that kids can ask a lot of tough questions.
Is a toothpaste real? Little crabs have eyebrows. Do you think they're a mermaid?
If you had a superpower, what would you choose?
When your children drill you with questions, log on to WSJS.com and ignore answering them while listening to Triad Today with Jeffrey Griffin, The Drive with Josh Graham, or Brian Kilmeade, Todd Starnes, or Rich Eisen. Trust me, you'll thank us. WSJS.com.
There's one place in Western Salem that puts the Q in barbecue. That's real Q. They cook their pork shoulders over wood coals for 10 to 12 hours, then they hand chop it and smother it in their own secret sauce. Real barbecue lovers know if it ain't over wood, it ain't as good. Real Q's traditional barbecue has folks coming from all around. For the best barbecue in Winston-Salem, take it from me, Porky. Eat me at Real Q. 4885 Country Club Road, open Monday through Saturday, 10:30 till 8 p.m. I'll see you there.
Do you know the secret to losing up to 1 pound of fat every day? Hi, this is Dr. Darcy Ward with Winston Weight Loss, and I know the secret. Our unique weight loss program makes it easy to lose weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. For your free consultation, go to winstonweightloss.com.
Hey, everybody. Jeffrey Griffin here. So the weight loss journey continues. I'm about a month into the program, and I've lost 45 pounds. Wow, can you believe it? It's the honest to goodness truth. Learn how you, too, can drop a pound of fat every single day, and let's do it together.
With Winston Weight Loss, there's no counting points or calories, no exercising, no prepackaged meals, no drugs, no surgery, and no injections with the risk of serious side effects. Many patients lose 20 to 30 pounds in about a month or two.
My wife Vicky's on the program. Vicky's lost over 25 pounds. Don't miss your big chance. Connect with the folks at Winston Weight Loss and lose the weight now.
For your free consultation, go to winstonweightloss.com. That's winstonweightloss.com.
Results may vary.
Jay Harris Financial, helping clients, making new partnerships, and now taking a few moments to invite you to call or stop in to introduce yourself. Preserve Your Wealth can be heard each Saturday morning starting at 10 a.m. right here on WSJS. Plan for a new, exciting financial year ahead and allow Jules Harris to share his thoughts with you regarding taxes, investments, Social Security, retirement plans, and much, much more. From Jules and Terry Harris, enjoy a wonderful start to the new year with Jay Harris Financial.
Hey, everybody, Jeffrey Griffin here. Are you ready for some football? Talking a little National Arena League football with the Carolina Cobras in the Snake Pit. That's the Greensboro Coliseum. Season tickets are available starting at $64 a piece. Get your tickets now online at carolinacobras.com or call the box office at 336-455-7232. The season opener is Sunday, March 24th against the Omaha Beef. Kickoff set for 3 p.m. Want to see you in the Snake Pit with the Carolina Cobras.
The Winston-Salem Fairgrounds, your one-stop source for entertainment in Winston-Salem. There's always something going on. Buy local, buy fresh at the Fairgrounds Farmers Market every Saturday from 6 a.m. till 12 noon. And that's year-round. And get ready for the summer concert series. For upcoming events, go to WSFairgrounds.com. The Winston-Salem Fairgrounds, your one-stop source for entertainment in Winston-Salem. WSFairgrounds.com.
At Jason's Deli, a lot of thought goes to what they put in their food and what they take out of it. Why the new Honey Mustard? Antibiotic-free grilled chicken breast, bacon, Swiss, avocado, and honey mustard on pressed sourdough.
And don't forget the ice cream.
And the ice milk used for Jason's Deli Soft Serve is comprised of 100% natural ingredients, and it's free to all our diners. Because everyone deserves dessert, Jason's Deli of Winston-Salem. It's a family thing.
Ready? Set sports.
This is The Drive with Josh Graham.
This was a request of mine. Do you have any idea why I'm playing Lil Durk right now, WB?
I don't. Happy to do it, though.
Don't blame me. Blame Matt Norlander, because before every tournament at CBS, he texts every coach that makes the NCAA tournament and asks who his favorite artist is.
Huh.
Can you guess which of our state's three coaches in the NCAA tournament said Lil Durk is Kevin Keats?
Gotta be Kevin Keats. Come on.
Your answer. It's Hubert Davis.
What?
It's live action.
Do we believe him? Or did he Google, who's the hottest artist right now that recruits like Lil Durk? Let's go.
That just seems more Kevin Keats. I thought of Hubert, but I'm like, no, that's Kevin Keats.
Kevin Keats's answer, Michael Jackson.
Oh, he just got some brownie points with me. I love that.
Then we go to John Shire. Drake.
Not Mike Posner?
Posner?
Posner.
Is the answer? There were other coaches that Matt Norlander apparently texted who were on the cutting edge, like were close to getting into the tournament. He wanted to text those who were on the bubble, too, just in case they get in. Steve Forbes answered Fleetwood Mac.
Great answer.
Yeah.
You can find that list on CBSSports.com. Trying to find some noteworthy ones. Hickory's Rick Barnes, who's the coach at Tennessee. Carrie Underwood.
Nice. Did we get Tony Bennett?
Tony Bennett likes Maverick City Music. I imagine that's a gospel group. I think I might be Christian music. Double check that for me. Maverick City Music. You watch, it's going to come back like Megadeth type music that Tony Bennett's listening to. Some of these are interesting choices.
They are a Christian group.
There you go. Coach Bucky at Samford, like Sam Cooke.
Okay.
Love that. Brad Brownell, Chris Stapleton.
I could see that.
Shout out to Colgate. Matt Langell is a Coldplay fan. That puts a big smile on my face.
Mm.
Got some Toby Mac listeners in on that. Greg Gard likes Luke Combs. John Calipari, Drake. Drake is the answer there. Mark Pope, BYU. Taylor Swift. That sounds about right. A lot of Bruce Springsteen fans. How did Rick Pitino answer that question? Oh, CCR. Got it.
Who's CCR?
<sighs> 28-year-old WD for the first time, everybody. I'll let you Google that one.
Yeah.
Will Pelagic, he'll be here in about 10 minutes. While we're thinking about this, let's pick out your movie for next week. Started going through it. WD, your birthday's yesterday.
Yeah.
28 years old. Doing the math in my head, that means March 18th, 1996. That's when you were born.
Correct.
Here were some movies that were released, that were in theaters.
I like this.
March 18th of 1996. Happy Gilmore.
Wow.
Have you seen Happy Gilmore?
I have.
Toy Story.
Of course.
Mr. Holland's Opus.
Well,
that movie will make you cry. It's on Disney Plus. It's very good. Richard Dreyfuss. You should check it out. Primal Fear.
Well,
do you know what that is?
Well,
courtroom movie. I love a good courtroom movie.
Me too.
Out of those four, I like Primal Fear the most because it's a very young Edward Norton. This was his breakout role, Edward Norton. And you also have Richard Gere. So Primal Fear is going to be one of the four choices. That's going to be the birthday month movie for you. Speaking of court cases, court movies, WD, there is a perfect movie for us to put on this list. In fact, I hope this wins the poll. You know who's coming to Charlotte? Texas. When you think Texas fans, what do you think of?
Matthew McConaughey.
All right, all right, all right. Carolina's also there.
Go Tar
Heels. Yeah. What was that, Matthew, on the show?
I do say go Tar Heels.
He did say that. So there's only, I could throw a bunch of movies at you. I doubt you've seen Interstellar. I doubt you've seen any of these other ones that I have. We Are Marshall. I doubt you've seen Ghost of Girlfriends Past, which is really good. The movie has to be on this list, A Time to Kill. Scott writes in, Dazed and Confused. You've seen that. We made you watch that.
I really enjoyed that.
A Time to Kill is the perfect movie, and here's why. Samuel L. Jackson, breakout role in this movie. He's a Tennessee fan. Born in Tennessee, Samuel L. Jackson.
I didn't know that.
Also, ECU grad or ECU alum, Sandra Bullock's in it. So I'm biased there. The movie, set in Mississippi, Mississippi State, is at this regional too.
Yeah.
So we're checking Tennessee, we're checking Mississippi, we're checking Texas with A Time to Kill being the second choice. Now we got to look at other alumni at other schools that are also there. I went through Howard alumni, Chadwick Boseman. Have you seen Black Panther?
Well,
you didn't see Black Panther?
I know. I
have. How about 42?
Well,
you don't like that movie, though.
Hate that movie.
You don't like that.
Part of me wants to put it on here just because of that. Anthony Anderson from Blackish went to Howard. Have you seen Harold and Kumar?
Well.
Me, Myself, and Irene?
Well.
Marlon Wayans went to Howard. White Chicks?
Well.
Scary Movie?
Well.
I never got that much into Scary Movie because I actually like real scary movies.
I don't know what to do with any of that.
Just put Black Panther on there, call it a day. Well, that'll win the poll.
You know what I'm going to do? Just to see what would happen. I think I might throw 42 on that poll.
I like that.
Just
idea.
To see what would happen. Michigan State alumni, Tom Sizemore. You've seen Heat.
Yes.
Enemy of the State was on the poll next week or last week, so we won't put that back on the poll. Have you seen True Romance?
Well,
Brad Pitt, Quentin Tarantino wrote the movie. Crazy performance by Gary Oldman. Yep, that's on the list. Or we could go James Caan. Thief?
Well.
Misery?
Well.
Yeah, we'll do True Romance over that. But so the four options that we have now for people to vote on. We've got 42, Primal Fear, A Time to Kill, True Romance.
WD needs more of a thinking man's picture.
Ian Eagle going to call his first Final Four for CBS this year. He's in Brooklyn calling Duke this week. Yes. So there you go. You can vote on that poll at WSJS Radio, at Josh Graham Show, literally putting this up as we speak right now. True Romance, Primal Fear, A Time to Kill, or 42. Which movie should WD watch for the first time?
What if 42 wins in a walk? Are you going to allow that to happen?
I don't know.
Will this be a true democracy?
I honestly don't know. We'll see how the poll shakes out. This year was the closest I've come to not filling out a bracket, by the way. See, a bracket, you know, I don't have time to fully explain my ways. We could maybe revisit that in a bit. But I'm just saying that this is something that we've talked about in past years, never end up following up on. Some might not understand that, but maybe we can get to that another time. Because a car is a car, right? No. A car is not just a car. Especially when you're talking about Mercedes-Benz of Winston-Salem. Take a test drive today. That's what they want you to do. Feel the difference. Don't believe there's a difference? Take a test drive. Feel the difference. Interest rates. As low as 4.99 APR up to 72 months on select new models. Visit Mercedes-Benz of Winston-Salem today at 691 Jonestown Road and take a test drive. And while you're at it, make sure you're subscribed to our podcast channel. Search The Drive with Josh Graham, iTunes, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and Anchor. You can find the stuff at WSJS.com as well. You can find all the links there. Our YouTube channel has been blowing up in recent weeks, and it's only going to get better with us being in Charlotte for NCAA regionals this week. Those four movies, though, I already see a lot of reaction to them. 42, A Time to Kill, Primal Fear. We got some variety here. There's no doubt. And True Romance. To pick three out of those four movies, I'd be completely cool with them winning the poll. But we'll see what happens. Tom Sutton just texted me, True Romance. I think I'm with them on that. Time to Kill would be great, too. There's a line I want to yell out loud right now, but I think I'll save it. There's a summer event that was announced today that you should add to your sports calendar. And we'll tell you what that is with a special guest joining us next.
Nothing but net in March.
March Madness is back.
Can you believe it?
Follow the madness of March right here on WSJS. Powered by Carolina Core FC, BJ's Restaurant and Brew House, Precision Garage Door, East Coast Wings and Grill, and Heritage Hardwood Floors.
I live for March Madness.
We'll have complete coverage of the NCAA way to the national championship game.
You're looking for March. I know just the spot.
It's game on for March Madness on WSJS.
It's opening week at the Snake Pit. The Snake Pit? Yeah, the home of your Carolina Cobras. And the Cobras' first home game is this Sunday at
SRN News, I'm John Scott. Heavy fighting raging around the Gaza Strip's biggest hospital and surrounding neighborhoods. The Israeli military says it has killed 50 Hamas terrorists in the hospital. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says he remains determined to carry out a ground invasion of the southern Gaza city of Rafah, despite misgivings by President Biden. Inflation remains a top concern for small businesses. which reported lower optimism in February. The National Federation of Small Business Optimism Index fell to 89.4 in February, the 26th consecutive month below the 50-year average of 98. The Dow was up 320 points today, the Nasdaq gained 63, and the S&P 500 added 29 points. This is SRN News.
Let's see, if something costs less, but people are happier with it, that sounds like something to look into, and that is MediShare. And maybe you've heard switching to MediShare to pay for healthcare can save many families up to $500 a month, and that's huge, but it's also true people are way more satisfied after making the switch too. The member satisfaction rate for MediShare is double that of the typical health insurance plan. Double. MediShare works too. It's been around for 30 years. Members have shared more than $5 billion of each other's bills. People love having telehealth and a huge nationwide PPO network. So yeah, really, you can save a ton and like it better. Imagine being happy with how you're taking care of your healthcare. So if you're self-employed or part of the gig economy, or you just want a plan you're happy with, you can call right now and get a price within 2 minutes. See what you can save. This is a very, very smart use of 2 minutes. Here's the number you need. Call 844-45-BIBLE. That's 844-45-BIBLE. 844-45-BIBLE.
With SRN's four-time chair of the house. In the NBA, the Philadelphia 76ers regained control late in the fourth quarter for a key Eastern Conference win over the Miami Heat.
The 76ers pull away the fourth quarter for a 98-91 win over the Heat. Up by 14 the start of the quarter, Philadelphia saw Miami rally to tie the game at 85. They retook the lead for good on a three-point basket by Buddy Hield and got key baskets by Kyle Lowry that preserved the win.
Got some shots that made win, and we were patient and we were poised.
Tyrese Maxey had a game-high 30 for the Sixers, who moved into the sixth spot of the Eastern Conference standings.
I feel like guys are, you know, coming back or whatever, and we need to be stepping in the right direction come playoff time.
Bam Adebayo and Mike Rozier had 20 for Miami. Michael Luongo, Philadelphia.
Other winners included Cleveland, Boston, Chicago, Minnesota, New York, the LA Lakers, and Sacramento. This is SRN Sports.
Piedmont Triad area weather. Looks like our next big storm system will be rolling in on Friday and into the weekend with some rain. For now, we'll stay clear for the overnight hours, mid-30s on our low. Sunny, windy, and warmer for Wednesday. We're in the upper 60s on the high. That wind gusting to about 30 miles an hour. Wednesday night looks clear, and then sunny and low 60s for the high on Thursday, showers and 50 Friday. I'm meteorologist Steve Hamilton for News Talk Sports for the Triad, WSJS.
Wake up with the morning show. When you get out of your bed, you'll be raring to go. La-la.
Coming up on the next Triad Today, Steve Alford from the University of North Carolina School of the Arts. We'll get online with Chase Vaden. We'll go on the road again. Susie will be here with This Week in Carolina History and another edition of Helping Hands. Don't miss me. I'm Jeffrey and Christian Snyder on the next Triad Today. Bye-bye.
WSJS, the home for Charlotte FC soccer. The voice of Charlotte FC, Will Pelagic, joins us now. Willie P., you got to see the first goal in history of Charlotte FC a few years back. Then, over the weekend, you saw the first ever marker for Carolina Core FC, which we've been telling you guys about. New soccer club, home to the Triad in High Point. The Core ended up winning that match in a penalty shootout. How cool was that to see?
It was interesting. It actually had a lot of parallels to the team they were playing, Crown Legacy's first match in their history a year ago, where Crown Legacy was able to get a point with a goal in stoppage time with Nick Scardina. Ironically enough, Scardina scored on Sunday as well for Crown Legacy. And it's going to maybe start up a pretty big rivalry in MLS Next Pro now with those two teams separated by basically a little bit over an hour. I'll be pulling for Carolina Core every game except two or three, however many we play them every year, because obviously my initial support goes to Charlotte FC's player pathway. But they brought a lot of fans and a lot of excitement, and it just is a further testament that soccer is blossoming here in the Carolinas.
Oh, yeah. We've got gear and everything. They look good. It's a cool logo. Shout out to the Carolina
and some Carolina soccer icons, too, with Eddie Pope and Roy Lassiter. I mean, you can't really get any higher than those two guys, ironically enough, on opposite ends of the basketball rivalry from the weekend as well.
I was about to say, Roy Lassiter, very happy about what happened Saturday night. We had him in studio a few weeks ago. Shout out to the Wolfpack as well while we're talking with Willie B. Will Pelagic joining us here. Charlotte FC at home Saturday. That's certainly a match that you should be circling this weekend. Another match you should be circling in Charlotte as well. We learned today, August the 6th, will be a match between Real Madrid and Chelsea playing at Bank of America Stadium. Where does that match rank among the soccer events that we should be circling in the Queen City this summer?
Well, it's definitely up there because we have a lot coming to the Queen City this summer. We've got Copa America, which is going to be a semifinal match for the South American Championship. That could include Argentina, or that could include, obviously, Brazil, maybe, and also the United States of America, because they're participating in a guest capacity in that. Argentina could come, obviously, in the third place match, I should say. They're on the other side of the bracket, so I beg your pardon there. But there's other things as well involving Charlotte FC with the League's Cup starting, so we at least are guaranteed one home game against Cruz Azul, which is a big team out of Mexico. And then this friendly, which Chelsea gets to come back to our building for the second time in 3 years. Of course, they were here in 2022 when Charlotte FC beat them in the 2022 campaign. So very excited to have those guys back and excited to bring in a very exciting Real Madrid squad that includes big names like Vinicius Jr. and Jude Bellingham, as well as Luka Modric. These are very, very world-class names. And on the largest stage, Real Madrid was in the Champions League final a year ago and competing, of course, in it this year as well. So it was a real intriguing thing when we came to find out that this was coming to Charlotte. And it's also part of just a big summer of soccer across the Carolinas. We got Man U and Liverpool going up down the street in Columbia. I know that Keenan's got another rough friendly as well this summer. There's just so many different things happening here. And the Carolinas are a soccer state, or they are soccer states, if you will.
This Saturday, Charlotte facing Columbus Bank of America Stadium. I will be in Charlotte Saturday. So if the Saturday games for the NCAA are afternoon games, maybe we could swing that at 7:30.
Yes,
I'm hoping.
Come on by,
and I can circle that. Speaking of which, what is your strategy when it comes to bracket building? We visited with Jordan Surenkamp a short while ago, Swarm coach, and he has two or three brackets in front of him. WD strikes me as a guy who fills out multiple brackets. For me, it's one bracket. This is what I think is going to happen, and I'm not deviating from that. How about you?
I used to be a multiple bracket guy. I used to be somebody who would, like, you know, not look at it the first day, fill it out on Monday, and then tinker with it Tuesday and Wednesday, and then finally submit it as late as I possibly could Thursday morning. I'm literally going to take, I've not taken one look at mine yet in my pool that I have with the guys at work. I'm taking the John Rothstein approach this year. The less you know, the better. So I'm going to get up tomorrow morning. I'm going to fill, after watching the first four games tonight, I'm going to get up tomorrow morning. I'm going to fill it out once and I'm going to forget about it. And then hopefully I'll wake up on Sunday and it won't be totally busted. So, like, that's the approach I'm taking this year. I probably watched less college basketball this year than I had in any other year. I basically watched the ACC and that was basically it. Didn't watch much of my alma mater because they sucked. So as a result, there's probably a lot more of a limited aspect that I go into this year with. But as we know in these tournaments, the less you know, like John Rothstein says, the better you actually perform.
I thought when you said you were going to have the John Rothstein approach, that just means that you're going to pick every Mountain West team to beat ACC schools and have a couple Big East teams in the Final Four.
January, February, Izzo, right? That's the way John Rothstein works.
Exactly right. Will Pelagic, we'll talk to you next week. Thanks for doing this.
We sleep in May.
There goes Willie P. I think I've had enough of the John Rothstein references. for today to transition things a bit. Registration for YMCA Camp Haynes and summer day camp open. Visit YMCANWNC.org to sign up for summer camps and activities. We'll circle back to the NCAA tournament in just a bit. Clemson trying to bring us all down. And by us, I mean all of us who love college basketball, dampening our moods, but also maybe bringing down the entire ACC too. But to quote the bad guy in Taken on the phone, good luck. Good luck to Clemson on that lawsuit. Because the crux of their argument, they've narrowed it a little bit more than FSU did based on what they filed today. They believe that once they get out of the conference, that their media rights should be theirs. It doesn't belong to the ACC through 2036. That's the way they're testing the grant of rights. And to that, I say, there's a lot of rich conferences and rich TV networks that really bank, more specifically the TV networks, but a lot of schools within conferences too, looking at you, Vanderbilt, looking at you, Northwestern, that rely on that contract going through 2036 and everybody kind of being banded together. Undoing that will create a lot of chaos. So it is incredibly unlikely that that would happen. So really, this is going to be similar to FSU in the sense of it's going to take some time. And the Tigers, while they're hoping for the miracle scenario where a judge lets them off scot-free and allows them to have their media rights after exiting the league without having to pay annually whatever the cost would be as part of that buyout cost, they, if that doesn't happen, they're really hoping for the most realistic scenario that they believe would be a positive is getting a figure from the ACC. That's what this is about. Let's shake trees enough to the point where the ACC says, fine, here's a number. And even if the number's outlandish, you still have the number. And then through private equity or whatever, you can raise that number and then hope once you join a conference, in Florida State and Clemson's case, that given if it's in the SEC or the Big Ten, how much more money they're making annually than what you're making, that eventually will pay off for you years down the line. But good luck with the argument that they're trying to make. Back to basketball. My pick for the national championship to win it all in Arizona, next on The Drive.
Start your day off with a king. Biscuit King. Try the hot, delicious Biscuit King breakfast platter. Crispy bacon with perfectly cooked eggs. Your choice of grits, gravy, or hash browns, and of course, a fluffy and buttery homemade biscuit. Biscuit King serves breakfast and lunch all day, every day.
Biscuit King, home of the good enormous biscuit.
Biscuit King is searching for full-time and part-time team members offering great hours, competitive pay in 4 locations. Join the Biscuit King family by applying in person at 3916 Sedgwick Street and High Point.
The Winston-Salem Fairgrounds, your one-stop source for entertainment in Winston-Salem. There's always something going on.
Treasure at the fairgrounds on the way.
Buy local, buy fresh at the Fairgrounds Farmers Market every Saturday from 6 a.m. till 12 noon. And that's year-round. And get ready for the summer concert series. For upcoming events, go to WSFairgrounds.com. The Winston-Salem Fairgrounds, your one-stop source for entertainment in Winston-Salem. WSFairgrounds.com.
Do you know the secret to losing up to 1 pound of fat every day? Hi, this is Dr. Darcy Ward with Winston Weight Loss, and I know the secret. Our unique weight loss program makes it easy to lose weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. For your free consultation, go to WinstonWeightLoss.com.
Hey, everybody, Jeffrey Griffin here. So the weight loss journey continues. I'm about a month into the program, and I've lost 45 pounds. Wow, can't you believe it? It's the honest to goodness truth. Learn how you, too, can drop a pound of fat every single day, and let's do it together. My wife, Vicky's on the program. Vicky's lost over 25 pounds. Don't miss your big chance. Connect with the folks at Winston Weight Loss and lose the weight now.
With Winston Weight Loss, there's no counting points or calories, no exercising, no prepackaged meals, no drugs, no surgery, and no injections with the risk of serious side effects. Many patients lose 20 to 30 pounds in about a month or two. For your free consultation, go to WinstonWeightLoss.com. That's WinstonWeightLoss.com.
Results may vary.
Rental Tractor sells the good stuff. For a limited time, buy a new Kubota with 0% financing and zero down, including first-time buyers on new Kubota tractors, mowers, and RTVs at Rental Tractor. Create and maintain your perfect space with durable Kubota equipment. Now available with 0% financing and no money down with approved credit. Equipping those who get the job done at Rental Tractor. We sell the good stuff. For details, visit RentalTractor.com.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time once again.
Now back to The Drive with Josh Graham.
So glad to have you on this Tuesday drive. You are listening to WSJS, News Talk Sports for the Triad, where the NCAA tournament opens up with the first half of the first four tonight. Virginia will be representing the ACC. Both winners tonight will advance to play in Charlotte Thursday. That's where we'll be doing our show Thursday morning.
It's live action, Tracy.
From ACC headquarters, Uptown Charlotte. Thursday and Friday's shows will be 10 a.m. to noon immediately following Triad Today on WSJS, leading into Westwood One's coverage of the NCAA tournament. But we'll get into the NCAA action tonight in just a bit, because right before the show started, I completed my bracket. Rather than break down March Madness game by game, or even region by region, let's just fast forward to Glendale. Let's just get to who's going to win it all. The North Carolina Tar Heels are going to win the national championship this year. Now, before anybody accuses me of being a homer or pandering to my audience, just know our show, for those who are new, is in its sixth year covering the NCAA tournament. This is our sixth March Madness. It is the longest running daily sports talk show in the history of the Triad. Do you know how many times out of those 6 years I've picked Duke or Carolina to cut down the nets? Well, before this year, never. Never in the first five. However, this year is different. But I can already feel some of you think, Josh, what about NC State this past weekend? If Carolina can't beat NC State in DC, what makes you think they could cut down nets in Glendale? Well, there is a historic precedent there. In the 64-team era of the NCAA tournament, which dates back to 1985, Carolina has won four titles. 1993, 2005, 2009, and 2017. None of those four championship teams won the ACC championship those years. They did not win the ACC tournament. So don't be deterred or read too much into conference championship week. That's a rule that you should apply to the rest of your bracket too, not just with Carolina. Plus, a Tar Heel win, it would be fitting with the Final Four being in Phoenix. The last time the Final Four was there, Carolina won the title with Joel Berry, Justin Jackson, Kennedy Meeks beating Gonzaga. Phoenix could be like Indy for Duke. It could be like what New Orleans historically has been already for North Carolina. Carolina has the best one draw of any of the top seeds. They got the one over Iowa State. Let's start there. Iowa State, number four in the AP poll yesterday, the final AP poll of the season. The selection committee gave a one seed to Carolina. They also sent them to Charlotte. That's good. You might say, oh, Josh, they don't want to face Caleb Love in the Elite Eight. Don't think Caleb Love's going to get to the Elite Eight. Last I checked, Arizona lost to a 15 seed last year. Arizona is coached by a guy who spent his entire career at Gonzaga before that. Gonzaga, not exactly a team that does very well in the month of March. And when you look at the teams that are tough, physically tough, mentally tough on the bottom side of that region, Baylor's a problem for them. Dayton could be a problem for them. Clemson could be a problem for them. Don't like Arizona in any of those matchups. Baylor, they're down this year compared to the team that Carolina faced a couple of years ago. Alabama, as a four seed, leaking oil. Carolina got a really good draw. One seeds. Another bracket tip. Generally smart picks to win it all. 26 of the 44 champions since 1979 were number one seeds. So, again, you might be asking, Josh, why the Tar Heels and not, say, UConn, who's the most popular pick? Well, there have been just two repeat champs since NC State upended UCLA in Greensboro back in 74. That ending a seven-year run that UCLA won the national championship. Only two repeat champions since. Duke 91-92, Coach K's first two titles. Florida in the mid-2000s, coached by Billy Donovan. Also, this is a really tough region for UConn. They might have drew the most difficult region of anybody in the field, at least if you subscribe to KenPom. KenPom has Auburn as the fourth best team in America. In UConn's region, they are a four seed who might get UConn in the Sweet 16. There are 11, a third of the automatic qualifiers in this tournament are in UConn's region. Teams that just got done winning a conference championship are in UConn's region. That's not easy at all. Also, Carolina has already played UConn. Played them in their backyard. Played them tough. So this Tar Heel team's not going to be scared to play UConn on that stage. Looking at my other Final Four teams, couple of ones, UConn, North Carolina. On the other side, a couple of three seeds. Kentucky and Creighton. That's my Final Four. Creighton in the championship, North Carolina to win. WD. What does that trigger in your head? North Carolina against Creighton in the NCAA tournament.
I like the sound of it.
2012. You remember?
Oh, God.
Kendall Marshall. What did that happen?
As B-Dot would say, damn you, Creighton! That'd
be quite a team to beat in the national championship game.
I'll say.
Just throwing that out there. The Tar Heels, my pick to win it all. You can reach out to the show on X at WSJS Radio. Give us a call, 336-777-1600. Will Dalton, the executive producer of this show. You watched Batman 1989 last night, the original Batman.
I did.
I'm Batman.
These are the options for next week. True Romance, Primal Fear, A Time to Kill, 42. What are you rooting for out of those four? You don't even know what half of those movies are.
I don't. I'm kind of...
Three quarters of the movies, maybe you don't know what they are?
I'm kind of pulling hard for 42.
Because that's the only one you know.
Well, not even that. I want to see what you're going to do.
Can you tell me True Romance, Primal Fear, or A Time to Kill? Can you tell me anything about those movies?
No.
Okay.
But I would like to see what happens if 42 runs away with this thing, because you hate it.
Don't even know why I bother even asking you.
No
question. Getting to tonight's NCAA tournament action. Because I'm not going to let Clemson suing the league usurp my fun today. Not going to let them steal my joy. We could save that for the five things at five and the 5 o'clock hour. We got games tonight. Even as an underdog, Virginia is not going to lose to Colorado State of the Mountain West Conference tonight. Not going to happen. Virginia is going to win this game, and here's why. Let's start with the national discourse. It's been absurd, the national discourse surrounding Virginia. You'd think the last team in would get scrutiny for getting into the field. Colorado State was the last team in. Virginia the second to last. Nope. All the shows are criticizing Virginia. We hate the way you play. You don't score. Feeds it to the ACC perception thing. The ACC always taking bullets. Nobody really crushing the Mountain West ever. So, of course, the ACC is the one getting blasted. Virginia hears all this stuff. Oh, what's your resume? How about winning 14 ACC games this year? Finishing third in the league with a double bye. And then out of the conference beating Florida and Texas A&M by double digits. Also, they should have been in the ACC championship game if they fouled before O'Connell was able to put up that shot. Tony Bennett even admitted that after landing in Dayton yesterday.
I believe I made a mistake at the end of the game that we had two fouls. We had decided to not foul. We fouled a 3-point shooter before. And then we had talked as a team and said, let's win it with our defense. And we got a stop with 5 seconds left, didn't foul. We were up three, got the rebound, and Isaac went to the line. And, you know, I was going to call timeout, but I didn't want to ice him, but should have had, you know, if I could do that over, should have had the guys at the line and thinking about it now, maybe fouled on that spot because we had some to give.
Let's not overthink this. It is the Atlantic Coast Conference against the Mountain West Conference. It is the team that finished third in the ACC this year that won a national championship 5 years ago with Tony Bennett as its coach, facing the sixth best team from the Mountain West Conference. I feel like Mugatu and Zoolander. I feel like I'm taking crazy pills right now. No conference in the history of this sport has been more successful than the ACC. Oh, but that's just ancient history, John. Let's do the last decade. Since 2015, no team has more Final Four appearances. No team has more national championships. No team has more elite, or no conference has more Elite Eight, Final Four, or national champions. Sweet 16. Whatever metric you want to look at in this tournament, the ACC is dominant. The Mountain West might be the worst conference when it comes to March performance. The Mountain West is 10-21 since 2013 in the tourney. 10-21. And if you think that sounds bad, half those wins belonged to San Diego State last year. So without San Diego State's run a year ago, that is 5-20 since 2013. San Diego State's not taking the floor tonight. Colorado State is. So it is a joke that New Mexico is favored against Clemson.
Send me that cash up.
And Virginia is an underdog against Colorado State tonight. But you might be thinking, Josh, where's the X's and O's? This is all just, you know, gas bagging. Where's the actual basketball analysis? How about this? We learned about the bracket Sunday night. These teams learned the same way that they were in. They had to travel last night. Here's what I know about Virginia. They play different than anybody else that Colorado State's going to play. That's a pretty short turnaround in prep time. I don't care that you have that great guard. They have two-time ACC player, defensive player of the year, Reese Beekman, to defend said guard. I think Virginia wins tonight and sends a message. But the ACC, duh, is better than the Mountain West Conference. And I think they win tonight comfortably. Comfortably. Hayes Permar, going to join us to play Skips or Plays with Hayes in hour three of the show. That hour beginning with a rundown of the top headlines of the day. Yes, including what's going on with Clemson. The five picks of five are next.
ZZ Top. And Leonard Skinner. One big night at the Greensboro Coliseum, Friday, March 29th, with special guest Blackstone Sharon. One show and you gotta go. Reserve your seats and maybe win tickets too. ZZ Top and Leonard Skinner from Live Nation and WSJS.
At Jason's Deli, a lot of thought goes into what they put in their food and what they take out of it. Try the new Honey Mustard Chicken Club 100% antibiotic free grilled chicken breast, bacon, Swiss, avocado, and honey mustard on pressed sourdough.
And don't forget the ice cream.
And the ice milk used for Jason's Deli soft serve is comprised of 100% natural ingredients, and it's free to all our diners. Because everyone deserves dessert, Jason's Deli of Winston-Salem. It's a family thing.
When you order food for work on EasyCater.com, we've got your back. Real humans are here to help with your order every step of the way, making sure everything goes right, even behind the scenes without you knowing, confirming and double confirming with the restaurant that everything is on track. If there's a problem...
Thanks for calling Easy Cater.
Call us anytime, day or night, and we'll answer in seconds. We're right here with 100,000 restaurants, working hard to ensure the food arrives on time and is ordered. Order 24/7 at EasyCater.com.
All the news that matters and more. WSJS Winston-Salem, Greensboro, High Point, Burlington. It's hot news. Online at WSJS.com.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters reporting. The Supreme Court lifted a stay on a Texas law that gives police broad powers to arrest migrants suspected of crossing the border illegally while a legal battle over immigration authority plays out. The Biden administration is suing to strike down the measure, arguing it's a clear violation of federal authority that would hurt international relations and create chaos in administering immigration law. Texas argues it has a right to take action over an ongoing crisis at the southern border. Five states are holding presidential primaries today, correspondent Donna Warder reports.
Primaries are being held in Arizona, Florida, Illinois, Kansas, and Ohio. Former President Donald Trump is expected to win easily in the GOP primaries in those states. And President Joe Biden is expected to win the Democratic primaries in four of those states. In Florida, Democrats canceled their primary and awarded all 224 delegates to Biden. Voters in California will move toward picking a replacement for former House Speaker Kevin McCarthy, who resigned after being forced out of the Republican leadership. I'm Donna Warder.
Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin vowed Tuesday that the U.S. will continue to support Ukraine's war efforts against Russia, even as Congress remains stalled over funding to send additional weapons to the front. Speaking at Ramstein Air Base in Germany, Joint Chiefs Chairman C.Q. Brown says the U.S. and its allies cannot pull back on supporting Ukraine.
Russia's plan is to wait out Western will to support Ukraine. This coalition must not let that strategy work.
U.S. defense officials found and used $300 million in contract savings to fund a new package of military aid for Ukraine, pulling weapons from Pentagon stocks. On Wall Street, a record day as the Dow was up by 320 points. The NASDAQ rose 69. More at townhall.com.
Listen. Relief factor, pain relief that's natural, pain relief that works, and pain relief that attacks the source of the pain. That's the experience of tens of thousands of Americans who are taking Relief Factor right now. See their incredible video endorsements at relieffactor.com and then order your three-week quick starter pack for just $19.95. That's less than a dollar a day. Find out if it can work for you like it works for me by ordering your three-week quick starter pack today. Relieffactor.com, relieffactor.com. Be the next success story.
Laura Trump provides a fresh and honest perspective on the issues that matter to you on The Right View podcast, now available on the Salem Podcast Network.
The number of Americans, and I think this is part of the problem right now, the number of Americans getting their news from TikTok quadrupled in the past 3 years. It really kind of terrifies me for what is to come for this country.
Subscribe to The Right View on Apple, Spotify, Google, YouTube, Rumble, or at SalemPodcastNetwork.com.
Piedmont Triad area weather. Looks like our next big storm system will be rolling in on Friday and into the weekend with some rain. For now, we'll stay clear for the overnight hours, mid-30s on our low. Sunny, windy, and warmer for Wednesday. We're in the upper 60s on the high. That wind gusting to about 30 miles an hour. Wednesday night looks clear and then sunny and low 60s for the high on Thursday, showers and 50 Friday. I'm meteorologist Steve Hamilton for News Talk Sports for the Triad, WSJS.
Step through and put it up off the window and got the roll.
Here comes Duke.
Steps through and dunks it down with two hands.
The Blue Devils are making their 28th consecutive NCAA tournament appearance.
He'll take the three. And there's the answer.
And making a run at championship number 6.
A clean look. And he hits a three.
You'll hear all the action right here.
Scoop it up. Got the roll. Flip it. Takeover mode.
Your home for Duke Blue Devil basketball is WSJS.
It's The Drive with Josh Graham. WSJS.
It's time for the five things at five.
All right, people, take five.
Brought to you by Precision Garage Door, where their five things are great service, dependable service, superior service, friendly service, and fast service. Here are the top five stories trending now.
They are brought to you by Precision Garage Door. Online, precisiondoornc.com. That's where you can book an appointment if you need garage door repair. And we understand if something goes wrong with the garage door, you want it taken care of immediately. Not like one of those phone companies that'll tell you, oh, your internet's out? We'll talk to you. How's next Tuesday sound? How's next Wednesday? No, they understand that this is an immediate need that needs to be taken care of. So sometimes it's same-day service. They can book an appointment with fantastic fantastic customer service. I can vouch for this. I had something wrong with my garage door about a year ago, and boom. They show up the next day, and they take care of the thing, and they're very clear on what exactly is happening with your garage door. Locally owned and operated, online, precisiondoornc.com. We run down the top headlines of the day, starting with...
Number 5.
Some breaking news in the NFL. After speaking with the Carolina Panthers, former Chargers wide receiver, former Clemson Tiger receiver Mike Williams visited with the New York Jets, and the Jets did not let him leave the building without a contract. 2 years, $15 million for Mike Williams. Panthers get Deontay Johnson. They should not be done at that point. I think you do need to add in the draft, maybe find somebody in free agency, but it seems pretty clear Carolina is not going to get one of those big ticket free agent type of options, especially when you're competing with teams that have Aaron Rodgers throwing the ball still. It is Mike Williams to the Jets. That is the breaking news of the hour.
Number 4.
The Carolina Hurricanes have quite a bit. The Canes have quite a bit going on right now, I would say. They have a game tonight at the New York Islanders. The Islanders are good. Carolina, though, fantastic right now. They've won 3 straight games altogether. On the road, they've won 5 straight. And they've gotten points in their last 8 on the road, 7 of those being wins. Carolina, a great road team, 20 road wins on the year. I think that's tied for 2nd in the Eastern Conference, still 4 back of the Rangers. They also unveiled Carolina new alternate uniforms that have a throwback C on the front. They're red. They have a walking pig, a walking stormy patch on one of the shoulders. Really digging this look for the Canes. Usually when you debut new logos and new uniforms, the reaction's negative. Most of the reaction to this has been positive for Carolina. A good sign for them and what should be a really popular jersey sold. I think this is even cooler than the Stadium Series jerseys a year ago.
Number 3.
I should also throw out there that the new additions Carolina has added looks really good. Evgeny Kuznetsov, 5 points in the last 3 games, 2 of those being goals. Jake Guentzel scored his first goal against Ottawa a couple nights back. He had the shootout winner against Toronto. Freddie Anderson, 4-0 since returning, only allowing 5 goals in those 4 wins for Carolina. Where am I at? Number 3, big night for basketball, not just because it's the first 4 tonight. Virginia, Colorado State, the winner playing in Charlotte. Howard facing Wagner, the winner, getting North Carolina in Charlotte. You also have the Charlotte Hornets.
Chicken salad!
Forgot that last part. They are in Orlando. Charlotte, not a good road team. Not very good. Orlando is. I think they have 40 wins so far this year. Looking really good. Watch out for Paolo Banchero tonight. The NIT is tonight. It starts with Virginia Tech hosting Richmond in a fun regional game. Boston College is at Providence.
Boston College.
And you also can look at Georgia Xavier. The winner of that game could be in Winston-Salem, assuming Wake Forest beats App State on its home floor tomorrow. We'll be doing our show live from the Jill tomorrow from 3 to 6 for Wake App State. We expect to be joined by App coach Dustin Kearns, hashtag take the stairs, Steve Forbes.
Well,
Stan Cotton should have a great show tomorrow. And again, I want to remind people, Thursday, we will be carrying NCAA tournament games from noon on, both Thursday and Friday. Our shows will be 10 a.m. to noon, immediately following Triad Today with Jeffrey Griffin. Thursday show will be in Charlotte at ACC headquarters, which we are looking forward to.
Number 2.
The Clemson Tigers are suing the ACC. This is a subject I want to hit on with some detail in just a little bit because there are funny elements to this. Hayes Permar will join us as well a half hour from now, but along with the chair of the ACC Board of Directors, Jim Ryan, Jim Phillips put out this statement, quote, "The ACC remains confident that its agreements with all of its members will be affirmed by the courts. Clemson, along with all ACC members, voluntarily signed and re-signed the 2013 to 2016 grant of rights, which is binding through 2036. In addition, Clemson agreed to the process and procedures for withdrawal. The conference's legal counsel will vigorously enforce the agreement and bylaws in the best interest of the ACC's current and incoming members. That statement was just put out. There was another one from Clemson's president, might have been from their AD, a short while ago. It's been a busy day, to say the least, trying to track down everything that's happening this afternoon. It's a bummer that we're having to talk about this rather than talk about basketball games. But at the heart of it, Clemson is saying that the ACC is hindering their ability to leave the conference, which they now seem like they want to do. Alrighty then. We'll talk more about this in just a bit.
Number one.
The number one story on the Five Things at Five, presented by Precision Garage Door. I will be very impressed if WD catches this line. It is a movie that we did make him see some time ago. Claire, the FBI is a national organization.
Oh, it's slipping me.
The town.
Oh.
I thought Claire would be a big hint there. There's only two Claires I know from movies. Claire from The Town, Claire from Wedding Crashers. Those are the two. Anywho, let's go to Madisonville, Tennessee. This is East Tennessee, where a woman claimed to be an FBI agent. And what did she do with those powers while attempting to be an FBI agent or claiming to be an FBI agent? She tried to close down a Waffle House. Why? Because its workers allegedly sold drugs from the back door of the restaurant, according to authorities. Yes, this woman's 60, charged with criminal impersonation. And apparently, they said that she went to the restaurant, and the restaurant employee said there was a woman inside claiming to be an FBI agent when police showed up. There you go.
I am an FBI agent.
That would have been a lot. I'm ashamed of myself.
Yeah.
How do I go to the town before I go to her walking into the Waffle House and telling the employees, I am an FBI agent.
Off your game.
She repeatedly said that she worked for the FBI. Other witnesses said that she said the same thing. She was arrested. Bail set to $1,000 during an arraignment. Oof. There you go. Pretending to be an FBI agent. This is the definition of being a Karen, so to speak.
Yeah.
Oh, they're selling drugs out the back. Oh, I'm an FBI agent. You better stop. What was her plan? Like, to get the drugs from them and then throw it away? I don't know.
Probably.
Okay, then. There you go, Tennessee.
That's how they do it.
Speaking of movies, let me check in on our poll question that we have. Trying to figure out what movie you're going to be watching next week.
Mm-hmm.
The options: True Romance, Primal Fear, A Time to Kill, 42. Early on in the proceedings, but 52% of the vote belongs to A Time to Kill. I don't appreciate you trying to sabotage the vote by telling people to vote for 42 because I hate it. I'm not even going to retweet that. Not going to retweet it because I wouldn't put it past the audience.
Yeah, but you liked it. Yeah, but you liked it.
I like you.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I liked it out of a reflex.
Yeah.
Coming up, why Clemson's suit is the most Clemson thing they could have possibly done. Keep it here on The Drive.
Bend a knee to the Queen City. The crown belongs to Charlotte.
Cross into the area. Save made by Kalina. It goes to ground and covers it up.
Saturday night. After three straight road games, the boys in blue return to the bank for a date with the Columbus Crew. Live coverage starts at 7. First kick at 7:30.
It's a really important cutout by Christian Kalina there. Collapsing down to his right-hand side. Cutting out the delivery there.
Your home for the Charlotte Football Club is WSJS.
Rental Tractor sells the good stuff. For a limited time, buy a new Kubota with 0% financing and zero down, including first-time buyers on new Kubota tractors, mowers, and RTVs at Rental Tractor. Create and maintain your perfect space with durable Kubota equipment. Now available with 0% financing and no money down with approved credit. Equipping those who get the job done at Rental Tractor. We sell the good stuff. For details, visit RentalTractor.com.
Do you know the secret to losing up to 1 pound of fat every day? Hi, this is Dr. Darcy Ward with Winston Weight Loss, and I know the secret. Our unique weight loss program makes it easy to lose weight, get healthy, and get your energy back naturally, safely, and effectively. For your free consultation, go to WinstonWeightLoss.com.
Hey everybody, Jeffrey Griffin here. So the weight loss journey continues. I'm about a month into the program, and I've lost 45 pounds. Wow, can't you believe it? It's the honest to goodness truth. Learn how you too can drop a pound of fat every single day, and let's do it together.
With Winston Weight Loss, there's no counting points or calories, no exercising, no prepackaged meals, no drugs, no surgery, and no injections with the risk of serious side effects. Many patients lose 20 to 30 pounds in about a month or two.
My wife Vicky's on the program. Vicky's lost over 25 pounds. Don't miss your big chance. Connect with the folks at Winston Weight Loss and lose the weight now.
For your free consultation, go to WinstonWeightLoss.com. That's WinstonWeightLoss.com.
Results may vary.
Join the Carolina Corps for the Cup. The 2024 U.S. Open Cup match will be played this Thursday, 7:30, at the UNCG Soccer Stadium in Greensboro. To purchase tickets for the Cup, learn more about how you can become part of the Carolina Corps, the latest team news, player updates, and events, or become a season ticket holder, visit CarolinaCorpsFC.com.
We must talk.
Go ahead. Talk back to the drive with Josh Graham.
Hayes Permar joins us in 15 minutes. I wish all we were talking about today, March Madness games that tip off tonight, including Virginia in action against Colorado State. That might be included in best bets in just a bit, by the way. But then Clemson had another ideas. We've got to talk about another school suing the ACC. By filing a lawsuit against the ACC in South Carolina this morning, Clemson is following Florida State's lead in challenging the ACC's grant of rights. They're starting the process here of exploring an exit from the league. The timing of this suit might be the most Clemson thing ever. You might as well call it Clemsoning. Except this definition is a bit different. It used to be Clemsoning was you're in line to win the league and then you lose to Boston College in the final month of the season.
Boston College?
That's what Clemsoning used to be. Now Clemsoning is this version. It's defined by doing something that showcases how little you care about anything other than football.
That was a troll.
That's what Clemsoning is in this context. Today's lawsuit is quintessential Clemson because they filed this the day the NCAA tournament tipped off. An NCAA tournament that Clemson is in. Remember last year? Brad Brownell, his team's left out, should have been in. Everybody's nuclear mad, should have been in the tournament. Well, now they are in the tournament. And the Clemson Athletic Department's like, people are talking basketball a bit too much. We can't let Brad Brownell have this week. We're just going to decide to sue the league. We're going to do that now. And it tracks for their athletic department. Just Google why former Clemson assistant basketball coach Steve Smith didn't have his contract extended about 5 years ago because he was caught on an FBI wiretap not breaking rules but stating a fact. Hey, if our athletic administration cared about basketball remotely as much as they care about football, Zion Williamson probably would have come to school here. Grade A sin in Tigerland. You can't be criticizing football. Oh, you want to know how much we care about football down here? Just saying a fact like that, you're out. You're not coaching anymore, Steve Smith. So why sue now? Why do it now? Well, there are two reasons for that. Number one being, we know about the 14-team playoff model. Those details leaking at the end of last week. The 14-team playoff that starts in 2026. Florida State hopes they're out of the league by then. Maybe Clemson as well. Because that's when it starts. The SEC and the Big Ten, higher up in the totem pole for who gets spots in the playoff. Clemson and Florida State want to play at the top level of football. By definition, the ACC will not be that in this next iteration of the playoff when the SEC and the Big Ten command more money. Each year, they command more automatic qualifier spots. So yeah, that's where those schools want to be. So that's reason number one. And we learned today that ESPN is still going to be the exclusive home of the college football playoff from 2026 to 2031. ESPN president Jimmy Pitaro announced that this morning in an interview with Axios. The second reason why now, Florida State has a hearing with the ACC in Charlotte on Friday. And this is Clemson's way of adding more pressure to try and perhaps get a figure, a get-out cost to leave the conference. Give us a number. That number doesn't exist yet. Give Florida State a number. So then Clemson has a number. So through private equity or whatever, they can get out of the league some way. But this does feel different than Florida State. It does feel different for this reason. FSU never really felt like a true member of the league. Not because the ACC was standoffish towards FSU, but the other way around. FSU was always quick to let people know, we're a lot better than you guys at football. It's our thing. We're not, you guys care about your basketball and do your stuff in the winter months. We're going to dominate in this football thing. And that's kind of who they've been. They never really felt like a true member of the league. We don't know an ACC without Clemson in it. Clemson was a founding member. They had representation in the room, that smoke-filled room in Sedgefield, at the Sedgefield Inn next to Grandover. 71 years ago. We don't know an ACC without them. So the ACC is going to fight Clemson the same way they're fighting Florida State right now. We'll see how successful the Tigers and the Seminoles are. This is probably going to take some time, but the process is beginning for the Tigers, just like it begun for Florida State right before the calendar flipped to 2024. However, the timing of Clemson doing this, quintessential Clemson, otherwise known as Clemsoning. Before we hand out bets, invest bets.
Send me that cash out, fam.
Have you signed up for Underdog Sportsbook yet? It's a different app. If you don't see Underdog Sportsbook come up when you first search it on your Droid or on your iOS device, try Underdog Sports. You can find it there as well. Sports betting, you know, it's arrived in North Carolina, but Underdog now entering the game. Underdog Sportsbook, North Carolina got it first. For years, they've been creating their own technology, working behind the scenes to have a great user experience sportsbook app, and they have achieved that. As somebody who's been playing around with it behind the scenes, having a great time in doing so. Here's some incentive to download the Underdog Sportsbook app and sign up with the promo code THEDRIVE. If you were to use the promo code THEDRIVE, you get a first bet mulligan. What's that mean? It turns up to $1,000 as bonus funds if your first bet loses. That means if you put $1,000 down on a bet and it misses, they tell you, we got you, fam. Have another run at it. Pretty cool. That's Underdog Sportsbook, promo code THEDRIVE. Must be 21 in order to gamble and present in North Carolina. Gambling problem? Call 1-877-718-5543 or visit morethanagame.nc.gov or call 1-800-GAMBLER. Terms, conditions, and restrictions apply and can be found in the Underdog Sportsbook app. Let's dive into today's best bets.
I'm not a betting duck.
Care to make it interesting?
You know you do.
You're on. Call me in on this.
Your best bet.
But my money's on the other team.
This is Josh's Best Bets.
Worth noting, we started our week off right yesterday. WD, remember what we handed out?
What did you hand out yesterday?
T-Wolves minus six and a half.
That's right, Minnesota.
Sorry, John Collins.
Yeah.
Whew. Anthony Edwards stuffing one.
Yeah.
He said it was the best dunk of his career. That's saying something, if that's the case. Also, a shout-out to former Duke Blue Devil Jalen Johnson's dunk over Austin Reeves on the first possession of that Hawks-Laker game last night. T-Wolves cashed minus 6.5 by winning by 10 in Utah. Tonight's play is a simple one. Virginia, money line. Disregard the 2.5, even if you could get it 3 some places. Nope. Money line. You take the Hoos. Just this stat that we'll throw out again. Virginia, third best team in the ACC this year in the standings. Good non-conference wins. Won a national title 5 years ago. Difficult team to scout for on short prep. A team that should have been in the ACC championship game if they chose to foul rather than let O'Connell shoot. Virginia's in a conference that is the most successful in college basketball, and they're facing the sixth best team in the Mountain West. A conference that, other than San Diego State's 5 wins last year making the run to the title game, is 5-20 since 2013 in the tournament. Give me the Hoos to send a loud message of what the ACC is tonight.
Send me that cash out, fam.
And you can make it fun, WD. If you don't like just plus 120, you want to have better odds on that, you can juice the value by taking the Magic money line. Don't know if I'd mess with the 9.5 against Charlotte. Charlotte's been a little pesky on the road of late, but Orlando's going to win that game. So that could get you up to 165. If you want to get it to plus 300, meaning you make $300 if you bet 100 on this, you can put the Magic down, Virginia down, and the Canes just to win. Money line, puck line against the New York Islanders tonight. Carolina, 5 straight road wins, 3 straight overall, and points in their last 8. That's what we're looking at tonight.
Give me that cash up, man.
So, whichever path you care to choose in those regards, you can, but Virginia is the main one that we're looking at tonight. Can guarantee you that Clemson going to be involved in the fray on Thursday. Can promise you. The ACC against the Mountain West. I've been waiting for this day for months.
I know you have. Going to be on a mission.
The ACC. I'm so tired right now with all the running around DC, and tomorrow we're going to be doing our show for the Joel and then Charlotte on Thursday. But I'll be awake at 9:15 tonight watching this game. Oh, you betcha. We're going to be locked in on that game. Check out our YouTube content. Check out our podcast content. Search In the Drive with Josh Graham. iTunes, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and Anchor. This is pretty cool. If you're watching our video stream right now, you can watch our show in addition to listening to it, in case you didn't know. YouTube, Twitch, and X. We have WSJS brackets that are on our website at WSJS.com. So if you haven't filled out a bracket, haven't printed one off, this is a really cool format that we have here. You can print off a WSJS bracket right now at WSJS.com. I don't want to spoil the surprise. WD has a special surprise for Hayes Permar from Sports Channel 8 when he joins us to play, as we do each week, Skips or Plays with Hayes. Also, vote on our poll if you haven't already. Josh Graham Show at WSJS Radio. What movie WD should be watching for next week? Because we're going to decide in the next 20, 30 minutes. Hayes Permar joins us next.
Start your day off with a king. Biscuit King. Try the hot, delicious Biscuit King breakfast platter. Crispy bacon with perfectly cooked eggs. Your choice of grits, gravy, or hash browns, and of course, a fluffy and buttery homemade biscuit. Biscuit King serves breakfast and lunch all day, every day.
Biscuit King, home of a good, enormous biscuit.
Biscuit King is searching for full-time and part-time team members offering great hours, competitive pay, and 4 locations. Join the Biscuit King family by applying in person at 3916 Sedgwick Street and High Point.
Artfield's
2024. Lake City, South Carolina transforms into a living art gallery as they recognize, celebrate, and share the artistic talent of the Southeast. Over 400 works of art will be on display from renovated 1920s warehouses, Lake City's art galleries, restaurants, boutiques, and shops. You're going to find inspiring art, live entertainment, and local food on every corner. Art Fields Competition and Festival is April 26th through May the 4th, and it's free. Lake City, South Carolina, a charming southern art town. Art Fields 2024.
With SRN News, I'm Keith Peters reporting. The former top military chief, General Mark Milley, and former head of U.S. Central Command testified before Congress Tuesday on policy failures by the Biden administration to adequately plan for or direct an evacuation in time to avoid the chaotic final days of the U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan. The final 2 weeks of the U.S. presence was marred by a deadly Abbey Gate suicide bombing in Kabul that took the lives of 13 service members. The last of four suspects in a bus stop shooting of eight Philadelphia high school students earlier this month was captured today in Virginia. The Marshals Service announced a 17-year-old was taken into custody about 12:15 p.m. at an apartment in Alexandria. On Wall Street, the Dow by 320 points. This is SRN News.
Let's see, if something costs less, but people are happier with it, that sounds like something to look into, and that is MediShare. And maybe you've heard switching to MediShare to pay for healthcare can save many families up to $500 a month, and that's huge, but it's also true people are way more satisfied after making the switch too. The member satisfaction rate for MediShare is double that of the typical health insurance plan. Double. MediShare works too. It's been around for 30 years. Members have shared more than $5 billion of each other's bills. People love having telehealth and a huge nationwide PPO network. So yeah, really, you can save a ton and like it better. Imagine being happy with how you're taking care of your health care. So if you're self-employed or part of the gig economy, or you just want a plan you're happy with, you can call right now and get a price within 2 minutes. See what you can save. This is a very, very smart use of 2 minutes. Here's the number you need. Call 844-45-BIBLE. That's 844-45-BIBLE. 844-45-BIBLE.
With SRN's four-time chair on the house. In the NBA, the Philadelphia 76ers regained control late in the fourth quarter for a key Eastern Conference win over the Miami Heat.
The 76ers pulled away the fourth quarter for a 98-91 win over the Heat. Up by 14 the start of the quarter, Philadelphia saw Miami rally to tie the game at 85. They retook the lead for good on a three-point basket by Buddy Hield. They got key baskets by Kyle Lowry that preserved the win.
Got some shots that made win, and we were patient and we were poised.
Tyrese Maxey had a game-high 30 for the Sixers, who moved into the sixth spot of the Eastern Conference standings.
I feel like guys are, you know, coming back or whatever, and we need to be stepping in the right direction come playoff time.
Bam Adebayo and Mike Rozier had 20 for Miami. Michael Luongo, Philadelphia.
Other winners included Cleveland, Boston, Chicago, Minnesota, New York, the LA Lakers, and Sacramento. This is SRN Sports.
Piedmont Triad area weather. Looks like our next big storm system will be rolling in on Friday and into the weekend with some rain. For now, we'll stay clear for the overnight hours, mid-30s on our low. Sunny, windy, and warmer for Wednesday. We're in the upper 60s on the high. That wind gusting to about 30 miles an hour. Wednesday night looks clear, and then sunny and low 60s for the high on Thursday, showers and 50 Friday. I'm meteorologist Steve Hamilton for News Talk Sports for the Triad, WSJS.
If you own your home or you're about to own your dream home, Heritage Hardwood Floors can do nearly anything, anywhere, in any style. They do hardwood, waterproof laminates, carpets, and gem floors. Well, whatever you can dream of. Here's the thing. Most homeowners don't know what's available and what's current. So please do this. See Jesse or Catherine at Heritage Hardwood Floors and see what the great fuss is all about. Find them online. Heritage Hardwood Floors. They have no ceiling. Heritage Hardwood Floors.
You're on the drive with Josh Graham. WSJS.
The AP's All-America teams released today. Here is your first team. UConn guard Tristan Newton. Tennessee guard Dalton Connect. Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. You know where Dalton Connect played last year, college basketball?
I don't.
Played at UNC.
What? Really?
For real.
He was a Tar Heel last year?
No. He was a UNC Bear, University of Northern Colorado.
Oh.
That's where Dalton Connect.
See, you set me up.
Played last year, for those who don't know. I don't think he's there anymore, but Christian McCaffrey's dad, Ed McCaffrey, used to be the football coach there just a few years ago.
Small world.
So anytime UNC's brought up, Christian McCaffrey immediately thinks, when he hears UNC, he thinks Bears rather than Tar Heels. Spent some time in Colorado. It could be a little confusing. Next All-America, Jamal Sheed, Houston guard, having an excellent year. He's the one prolific offensive player that the Cougars have, and they play amazing defense. A unanimous pick, Purdue's Zach Edey, and then there's Tar Heel guard RJ Davis. For those who have been asking about banner-related matters, RJ Davis already had one qualification. He won the ACC Player of the Year, so he was already set to go up there regardless of what these All-America teams voted. And even if he was second team, he would qualify for going into the rafters. First team pretty much locks that up. That's an incredible feat for RJ Davis to achieve. So he will be the first Tar Heel to have his number honored in the rafters since, it's really been a while, since the 2017 national championship team, Joel Berry and Justin Jackson. Both honored. Justin Jackson for winning player of the year, Joel Berry for winning most outstanding player in the Final Four, even though Kennedy Meeks was probably most deserving. I hope he still goes up there. Armando Bacot, you would imagine, goes up into the rafters as well.
Armando.
For being the Tar Heels' all-time rebounding leader. That was a bottle top. That
you dropping stuff over there?
Yeah, I am dropping stuff a little bit. Hayes Permar will join us shortly. Another fun story about one of those All-America players. Tristan Newton, do you know where he played basketball? Not last year, but the year before.
I have no clue.
East Carolina Pirate.
Ah, arg.
And here was my Tristan Newton story. So Tristan Newton's from El Paso. That's where he grew up. And somehow ended up at ECU before becoming this amazing guard who was amazing in the national championship game last year, helping UConn win a title. And he's a first-team All-America player this year. 2 years ago, he's playing for the Pirates. I go visit Sup Dogs. It's me. It's Ariel Epstein.
I think I know this story.
We're hanging out in Sup Dogs. I just got done watching a North Carolina NC State basketball game a couple of years ago. I forget who won that game. I think it was North Carolina. So down to Greenville, grabbing some food. And across the restaurant, not a big building. The Sup Dogs, great college bar. Across the restaurant, I see what I believe to be Green Bay Packers star running back Aaron Jones, who now plays for the Vikings, I believe.
He does.
So I walk over like an idiot and say, are you Packers running back Aaron Jones? And he says, yes. Why are you here? I'm here to support my cousin, Tristan Newton.
Get out of here.
I'm here to support my cousin, Tristan Newton.
Unreal.
That's what he said. And, you know, you might say to yourself, Josh, how do you recognize an NFL running back who at that point was not an All-Pro? I don't even know if he has been an All-Pro since then. They wear helmets. Are you a Packer fan? How do you recognize the guy? Well, he had a huge chain around his neck that said 33 on it. That might be a giveaway. Just call Hayes Permar.
Yeah, I think so.
Guy's tardy, and we got a surprise for him.
Ridiculous.
Unbelievable. And you do this on WD's birthday?
Yeah, Hayes.
All you wanted to do was to give Hayes Permar a birthday surprise, and he's tardy. He's not showing up for the segment. Unbelievable that Hayes will do that. You know, I'm going to spoil the surprise right now. Hayes Permar, in the month of March, has been known for putting together some March-related content. Shall we say March-related is a good way to put that?
Oh, yeah. He's good at that.
He is very good at that.
Not at answering the phone, but...
No. So, as a sampling...
Oh, there he is.
This is what we're doing, skips or play style, for Hayes, who now joins the show.
Yeah.
He has a lot of March-related content, and perhaps some content that's even related to news today regarding another ACC school that is suing the ACC that we can revisit to play skips or plays with. How does that sound, Permar?
Do I have news? Do you want to talk to the attorney who's suing him? Because
do you have him?
He's my attorney. He's right down the street. You want to hold on a second? Hey, Miller. No, I don't have him, but I can get him for you. I can get him for you. He is my attorney.
Or are you just kidding?
No, that is absolutely true. I'll send you the press release. My attorney is the guy that's suing, that's representing the tennis player. He also represents...
That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about Clemson suing the ACC.
I thought we were talking about UNC suing the ACC. Are we not doing that one?
No, no. That's another lawsuit that the ACC is dealing with. See, I was supposed to have... I am supposed to have Jim Phillips join the show when we do our show from Charlotte on Thursday.
Have a great day and go ACC.
Got a sneaky suspicion that that might not happen when we're in Uptown
Charlotte. Yeah, I missed Clemson suing the ACC. My bad. I saw a UNC tennis player suing the NCAA. I thought that was the sports lawsuit of the day.
But Hayes Clemson Permar
suing is news.
Hayes Permar is with us to play a special Hayes Permar themed edition of Skips or Plays with Hayes.
Hayes Permar is somewhat of a Renaissance man, an expert in the finer things, but he hangs his hat on music.
Loves his God, and he's no friend of Satan.
He was like, oh, six, getting busy with the sticks, been watching Big Mike and Lil Trank and Trip.
I just need a Zion and someone he can dunk on.
Today, Hayes will decide if this music is smash or trash, glows or blows. It's time for Skips or Plays with Hayes.
WD, do you want me to set these up?
You set
RIP Smash Mouth.
I'll let it rip.
Because I remember these songs when they dropped initially from Permar. And I think he will appreciate some of these older hits that we have. And since the Clemson news is hot right now, and Florida State suing the league too, there's a very apt lyric that I hope is included in what you pulled here, talking about Maryland. You remember this song, Permar?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
What song was this covering again? I'm trying to remember.
It's Mandy by Barry Manilow.
That's it. So this is Barry Manilow, but in Permar's version, talking about Maryland at the time leaving the league.
Just go without a fight. We won't really miss you. Got our grant of rights, so they can't take FSU. Oh, Maryland, we really do wish you were staying, but you're going away. Oh, Maryland,
great grant of rights line.
Don't think you can leave without paying.
And the juice starts today. Oh, Maryland, did we ever get our 50 mil from them? I feel like we let them off for a song, Josh Graham.
Yeah. I do like the end of that. There's a high note where the crescendo is have fun in Minnesota.
In Minnesota, Maryland. Yeah, that's a good one. That's a play. That's the song that kind of kicked off Sports Channel 8. That put us on a lot of people's radars.
Wanted to be near you,
that's a play right there.
Hayes Permar.
I just fully gathered the theme. And I feel like it's going to be heavy on plays. I'm just saying.
Oh, for sure. Undefeated.
Yeah. 2015 range. See, last night I was watching the Eras Tour Taylor Swift thing. It was on in the background while I was working on Disney Plus. And I think this might be my favorite Taylor Swift era when Blank Space came out. This is Blank Brackets.
Two bracket different picks. It's the best thing I've ever seen. The Canon 11 beat a 6. Oh my God, I picked Tom Green. Okay, try again. Xavier falls to Michigan. I think Duke could lose but win. I don't want to blow my Final Four before the weekend. Can I count on Kansas? Or will they go down in flames? Do I like West Virginia? Or is it Notre Dame? Got a 10 seed in the finals. Don't tell me I'm insane. Even though I blame the players.
This is almost on the level of I'm so bad at singing it. It's like funny, you know what I mean? Like it's almost in the like this clearly is not somebody that could pull off Taylor Swift, but I'm still giving it a play. There's some good tunes in there. And this is also one.
When
we do the 30 for 30 Sports Channel A documentaries. There's a couple like famous all-nighters for various reasons involved. And like this was one, it was just me walking around my house nonstop, just resetting up the camera. And like I'd barely moved into the house. So the furniture went, so I could just organize things however I need. I was like, I need this to be a TV room. All right, it's now a TV room. And I just remember shooting that whole thing. It's one of those that you don't appreciate how much video content goes into making just even like 2 minutes of video. If you set up different shots, it just takes hours. And I remember spending all night shooting that thing.
5 years ago, last song, you channeled, along with the Weather Moose, your inner Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper. This isn't Shallow. This is Bubble.
Tell me, Power Six, you really deserve all those multiple bits. You look down on me. I swear the Pac-12 is a one-bit league. I'm falling in the net rankings because my strength of schedule stinks. I'm hoping Selection Sunday's not as bad as I think. We're on a bubble. Season's in trouble. We're in the first four out. Don't let nobody ruin this party. I'm from the bubble.
Don't let Lunardi ruin your party is a great line. That makes me.
And the video has just the worst headshot of Lunardi there is.
Mm-hmm. Like, there should be Barstool or home team or whoever, home field, whoever like makes merch these days, they would crush it with a don't let Lunardi ruin your party. Enjoy March. Like, screw
Breaking
the bubble tea. Or something.
Breaking tea.
Make it so.
Breaking tea.
Oh, great stuff.
But no, that being on the bubble was a good one. That's a play.
Hey, Permar.
We have four movies for WD for next week. I made them somewhat themed. I wanted to find a movie. WD's birthday was yesterday, so I found a movie that was in theaters when WD was born.
His birthday. What's his birth?
Get out of here. He was born in March.
Birth. His birthday. He was born.
Yeah, he was born in March of 96. So Primal Fear was in theater that month. So I put that in there. True Romance, since Tom Sizemore is in that movie and Michigan State is in the Charlotte Regional. I think the most Charlotte Regional movie I could think of is A Time to Kill, because you got McConaughey. You have Samuel L. Jackson's a Tennessee fan. He's from the state of Tennessee. It's shot, and I mean, the movie's about the state of Mississippi, essentially, and Mississippi State's in Charlotte, too. And then we got 42 that is included in this. Which movie should WD watch next week?
Give me the titles again without the description.
True Romance, Primal Fear, A Time to Kill, 42.
I've only seen one of those movies.
What, is it A Time to Kill?
Yeah, so you got to go see McConaughey.
And I'm looking at the poll. 42% of the people say A Time to Kill. There's a line I want to say from Samuel L. Jackson that I'm probably going to save for next week.
Just McConaughey and Sandra Bullock just sweating the entire movie.
Sweat.
Just everyone's wet the whole movie.
Yeah. Is he gonna be at the Charlotte Regional? Can we get him to recreate that like he did when he joined us that one time?
I do say go.
Because Carolina's there too. Carolina's there too, just saying.
It's interesting.
No, that's true. And how about, I mean, how about your good friend and mine, Gary Hahn, keeping this train going? Just absolutely like you know, like a rider at the Capitol. He is not giving up, baby.
Let's go to the sidelines, Tony Hayne.
He is fighting this thing all the way to the end. You just gotta love it. So congrats to Gary. Keep it going, buddy.
Let's go to the sidelines, Tony Hayne.
See you, Hayes.
See you guys.
There goes Hayes Permar, Sports Channel 8. What do we got in skips or play? Oh, wait. What do we got? We know what we got in skips or play. What do we got in Ticket to the House?
Officer, I thought he was a turkey.
Next.
Listen to us online at the new WSJS.com. Listen to us on your smartphone at WSJS.com. Listen to us wherever and whenever you want at WSJS.com. Like when your flight at PTI, RDU, or CLT just went into its third delay.
May I have your attention, please? Flight 784 to Dallas has been delayed again.
You can hang out with us at WSJS.com, your online home for news, talk, and sports. WSJS.com.
Honey, we should get some new kitchen cabinets.
Now, before you go, oh no, and your wallet cringes, U.S. Cabinet Express in High Point has the solution. How? They're going to take the complication out of buying kitchen and bathroom cabinets with a free design consultation and a price breakdown for all cabinetry. Plus, take advantage of $0 down and 0% financing for 18 months. Now relax, take a deep breath, and visit the beautiful U.S. Cabinet Express showroom in High Point. Or go to uscabinetsexpress.net. That's uscabinetsexpress.net.
Honey, the garage door is making this weird noise.
Precision Garage Door, your local experts, they can spot these type of issues that you might not be able to see. Just like anything mechanical, your garage door might start making some noises, and you're better off finding out what is causing that noise. Precision Garage Door has free service calls with any repair. They can make your garage door run smoothly in a single day. Your garage door should make your life easier. Schedule your appointment today, precisiondoornc.com. Man, it is already time for March Madness. But I tell you what, I'm just going to sit on my couch, watch basketball all day, and eat chicken wings from East Coast Wings and Grill. They cook up fresh jumbo wings with your choice of 50 different flavors. And don't forget, kids are going to be able to eat for $1.99 on Wednesdays with the purchase of an adult entree. That's dine-in only. So do me a favor, go support the companies that help bring you this live March Madness broadcast. Visit EastCoastWings.com. That's EastCoastWings.com. Art Fields 2024. Lake City, South Carolina transforms into a living art gallery as they recognize, celebrate, and share the artistic talent of the Southeast. Over 400 works of art will be on display from renovated 1920s warehouses, Lake City's art galleries, restaurants, boutiques, and shops. You're going to find inspiring art, live entertainment, and local food on every corner. Art Fields Competition and Festival is April 26th through May the 4th, and it's free. Lake City, South Carolina, a charming southern art town, Art Fields 2024.
Now comes the moment you have all been waiting for.
All right, whenever you're ready.
This is The Drive with Josh Graham.
WD, I think you're going to be happy with The Time to Kill. That's a fun movie to talk about. It really is. So are you going to watch it before Monday night?
Yeah, because we got Bachelor, right? Is this the finale?
I think so.
Then yeah, I will be watching it over the weekend.
We'll see. I might be giving it a look tonight, honestly. Given
I won't be watching it
Thursday,
tonight.
Friday. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. I've got things that I'll be tied up with watching. Basketball and then The Bachelor. So A Time to Kill will be your movie for next week. Tomorrow we're going to be doing the show live from the Joel.
It's live action, Tracy.
Well, Steve Forbes, Dustin Kearns, Stan Cotton among the guests that will be joining us for a Wednesday show. I don't know what tickets we have to give away, but if we have some, they will be given away in Weekly Positivity.
Got that right.
That'll be fun while Wake is shooting around. Is there somebody up there whispering? And then we'll be doing our show Thursday and Friday morning from 10 a.m. to noon, including Thursday from ACC headquarters in Uptown Charlotte.
It's live action, Tracy.
Which I'm really looking forward to. So B be sure to be locked in. Let's close today's show, presented by Tar Heel Basement Systems. We take it to the house.
Past the 15, past the 10, past the 5 for the drive. We'll take it to the house.
1, 2, 3.
You know what to do by now if you got cracked brick, concrete cracks, or musty smells from the crawl space. I'll be honest. A few months ago, before we started learning about how great Tar Heel Basement Systems is, I wanted Nevada answer to that question. Maybe you need an answer to that question. Tar Heel Basement Systems is here to help you find the problem and provide the solution. There is not one-size-fits-all answers for houses. Tar Heel Basement Systems, experts. They have trained for years to be able to recommend the right option for you and your home. Once Tar Heel Basement Systems experts evaluate your home's foundation, the pricing's transparent, and your inspector will explain everything that goes into calculating the cost. Tar Heel Basement Systems understands your home as your greatest and most valuable asset. They have financing options to fit any budget, so don't wait for a small problem to turn into a big expense. Go to TarHeelBasementSystems.com now to schedule your free inspection.
So in this story, a man and a couple of other people were doing some hunting.
Why'd you say it like that?
Because they doing some hunting.
And you did it again.
Damn.
Why are you saying it like that?
Because they're hunting. Hunting and
they're
fishing.
Just hunting? Fishing?
Yes.
You're not a redneck.
Thank you.
You're not. And that, I don't even mean that as a compliment or an insult. That's just not who you are.
Hunting.
Hearing hunting. You talking hunting. About with a southern accent, it's the weirdest thing ever.
Is it? Well, anyway.
It's like listening to Daniel Craig in Knives Out doing his southern accent. Sounds like Foghorn Leghorn.
Oh, yeah. I can't imagine that would be good. So, in this case, this was around 7:30 a.m. on Saturday.
Sure.
And a man saw what he thought was a turkey. Mm-hmm. The exact quote was, "We was turkey hunting."
Okay, that's why you used the southern accent. Because quote, if it says we was.
Right. Okay. Right. We was turkey hunting.
Now it makes sense.
And I see what I thought was a gobbler. And he had had a decoy set up, and I didn't know he was there. So he actually, what he thought he saw was a turkey. It was actually a person.
Uh-huh.
And he shot him in the arm. So, got to put that out there. He is okay, but he got shot in the arm. And according
and not in a good way.
No.
See, like, you know how people say, oh, it was a shot in the arm. Not the good type of shot.
Now, luckily, he's up. He's walking around. He's good. But even the first responders are saying that he was not dressed the way it's recommended.
Yeah.
Because what they usually are supposed to do is have, like, some type of orange, bright orange. I had some bright Nike orange free runs back in the day. It looked like highlighters. A vest jacket of some kind, a hat, something that's going to give some indication that there's a human being present there. And this guy was wearing camo, so, you know.
Hunting! That's been a show for today.
Yeah, it has.
Enjoy the basketball tonight. Enjoy watching Virginia basketball. Thing of beauty.
Mountain West Conference, man. I'm excited about that.
If Virginia doesn't win, there's going to be a Sarah McLachlan in order. Go Hoos. I married into this. Got the gear on and all. We'll talk to you live from the Joel on a Wednesday drive.